Hello, our Hebrew nation. My name is Daria, and I would like to introduce the love of my life, my wife Aisha.
Hello.
We've been married for 15 years, and we are the founders of the Hebrew Israelites Recommence organization. We have been commissioned by the Most High Yah to galvanize His Hebrew people in preparation for our exodus. We're going back to our home nation, y'all, Israel.
That's right. All right. Our second exodus.
Our second exodus, yes.
So, shalom, family. Shalom. It's been almost 2 months.
Almost 2 months,
May 27th has been the last time we've been on here together. Mm-hmm. Honey, you've uploaded some videos, but we haven't been on here together for a while. And that's why, it's a reason for that. You know, we have finished our lesson 12. Parts 1 through 7, Reparations Now, that's what it's entitled. And we have been giving you some time, like the Most High told us, to do what we suggested in the last lesson, and that is to reprogram your minds, get ready to pop this off.
Right.
You know.
And the best way to do that, if you use that 2 month period to the best benefit for you, you should have started going back from the beginning of our lessons and working your way up to this point. If you haven't done that, I don't know what to say.
Right, well, we suggest you do that, but worst case scenario, start with lesson 12, part 1, then work your way up through part 7. We have that on our playlist. We already have it in sequence, and that is so that you'll know what this organization is about and what the what way we're headed as a nation. So it's like a crash course into what's going on right now, because this is going to pop off regardless. We want you to be prepared for it, and so that's why we have not been on. We've been handling kingdom business, you know, as far as the second exodus, as far as our nation. We love you, and we have been taking care of that, but we set back a little bit, you know, and let you all learn. We asked you all to learn, go back to the lessons, especially lesson 12, parts 1 through 7. So, now, you know, a lot of you haven't been doing that.
Yeah, because we can see with the numbers, I mean.
Well, I
look at the number. I know you two mess with numbers, but they ain't messing with them that much where I haven't really seen a significant jump in numbers.
Right. And also, we do want to talk about that. We want to talk about our last video. We're kind of going to do a recap. I'm about to jump right into the lesson. But I want you to understand, you know, our last lesson as we go into this one. But before that, you know, I think about 2 days ago, my husband did put up a video where he was rapping.
That was yesterday.
Yesterday. Okay. And so what you all need to understand is we've had some questions about this, and I'm going to address this for the last and final time. You know, on the song that you were rapping to, which is something that he wrote years ago.
At least in 2000, between 2001 and 2002.
Right.
I wrote that. So that's like 17 years old, those lyrics.
Right. And he's not, we're not trying to get any record deals or anything. This is how, like, some people write through poetry. Like, he tends to think through spoken word and rap. It's just part of our culture. It's just who we are. A lot of you, some of you are offended, you know, by the language that he's used. And that's what I mean when I say this is the last time I'm going to address this issue. Because, you know, if I didn't know who we were, I probably would question it. And that's fine. What I need you to understand, as I said, this is the last time I'm going to address this. He wrote that rap years ago, but he was trying to convey to you, this is the last video that you put up.
Yes,
recently.
Yesterday.
After you, oh, okay. He was trying to let you know, this is who I am. This is what I used to do. Everybody have a past. And this is why, this is how I feel moving forward. So when he says something like, you know, I'm taking my B with me, which is bitch.
Rolling all alone with my bitch, Nina Ross.
Right. Well, that's a gun. you know.
Nino and, Ross is street name for a 9mm for you squares who don't know, who want to act like, oh, the Most High, I wouldn't say nothing like that. Fuck you.
Stop, Daria. No, or I'm... if you say something like, you know, if he said, I'm all about those Benjamins, he's talking about the reparations that we're going for at this time. Listen, honey, calm down.
I am calm.
Let's be very clear. Once again, this is the last time I'm going to say it because we love you. Okay? This is for my righteous ones. We are not pastors. We are saved. Whether you believe that or not, I'm saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost. We do not believe in sin. We do not believe in fornication, adultery, homosexuality. We don't believe in that. But you show me in the Bible where curse words will send you to hell. Now, gossiping will, lying will, speaking malicious talk against one another, that will do that. Like she fat, or she, you know, talk slandering people. The word makes it clear. But as far as the curse words you use, that is not in the Bible. This is not me trying to twist the word of God. Go see it for yourself. My husband and I, we are who we say we are. We have been before the Most High for years. He told us specifically, don't change how you talk. Okay? And we've said this and we covered this in other videos. The Most High Yah is pissed right now. He's ticked off. He is here to deal with Esau. Okay? And get his kids back to Israel. He's not here to talk nice. We're not here to coddle you. Moses killed thousands of men with his own sword. Go look it up for yourself. Book of Jasher, by the way. Blood on his hands. David's hands were so full of blood from his enemy that God said, you can't even build my temple. You done killed too many people. But did God see either one of those men as murderers? No, he did not. And all we do is curse. We not the type of prophets that's going to talk nice. We not here for that. There's a time for war and there's a time for peace. We not here for the latter. We're not going to talk nice. And if you don't like how we talk, you can stay your ass here. We're here to get it done. We're not here to preach to you. We're here to deal with the enemy, cut the head of Esau off, and go the F home. See, I was nice. Yeah. I didn't curse right there. Okay? Get over it or stay your ass here. Okay?
And then this is what hurts me the most. God has sent messengers with good news, and no one is sharing the good news because they're scared of offending their church congregation, their friends. Why are you listening to them? They can stay here. I don't care. Right now, I'm ready to do my job, and I don't care if I liked you, if I liked the video you did, if I posted a video you did. If you're not on board, it's, again, roll or get rolled over. I'm finna push the fucking button, and I'm not turning back.
But you know, I don't think they get this. That's what we meant when we put up the John Wick premiere. We are what we were born to do, which is lead the second Exodus. My husband is leading the charge as the servant of the Lord. We went over that. Like I said, start with lesson 12 and work your way back up. Motherfuckers is going to die when we speak. Okay? Blood is going to be shed. Okay? And you offended because we curse? God is using us to kill the enemy. Get over it. Or stay your ass.
And to separate you from the enemy so you don't fall by the sword.
That's what I'm saying. So you don't like how we talk, you can stay your ass here. We not here. He said he's made my mouth like a sharpened sword. That means when you speak, people will die. Do you get it? They get it now? You think they understand that?
I don't care.
Right. Do you understand that a lot of Esau is not going to live once this shit pop off? It's going to be a result of what the prophets is saying going to happen to him. Like Moses killed the Egyptians with his mouth. But we're not here to talk nice.
But he's starting in his church with the Hebrews. So a lot of you motherfuckers ain't going to live.
Right. So get over that shit. You know what? At the end of the day, yes, this is how he expresses himself. Sometimes some people do it through music. I like to do, man, through worship music. He grew up on rap. We both did.
Yeah.
And that's how he speaks. So when he says, you know, the beat, that he's talking about the gun, when he says, you know,
all about the Benjamins.
He's talking about reparations.
Our gold.
Our gold.
And our land.
And if you don't like it, stay your ass here with Esau. Look, While Esau whipping your ass, at least he talk nice, he don't curse, right?
Right. There That's you your Creflo Dollars, your TD Jakes, yeah. or TD Snakes, your all
Paula White,
Joel Osteen. They never curse, but they send you straight to hell with that nice tongue.
Well, and not just sending them to hell, you're getting your ass whooped. Your kids can't even walk down the street. They're going to get shot by the police.
And riddle me this. Have any of them ever said anything or called me? Kind of, hell no, they didn't, because they already know I'm the truth. They stay the fuck away from me because they know I will melt their stupid asses.
Well, we're not here to... All we saying, because we love you, this is the last and final time we're going to say this, because I grew up in the church and you taught that people that curse not say.
Right.
Show me that in the Bible. Like I said, and when he said curses shouldn't come out the... Listen, if we were shacking up before we were married, having sex, all that, that is sin. That's clear. That's black and white. But when it says profane language in the Bible, he is specifically talking about when you gossiping, lying, and using your tongue to hurt others. He is not talking about the curse words that you use. You all thought the rapture was going to come and Jesus going to come down in the cloud. You didn't even understand that. So listen, you don't know everything. God would not we were born to do this. This is how we talk. Get over it or stay your ass here. But we love you, though. Okay, and I understand how you feel, but that don't make it reality. We're not here to talk nice. We're not here to be nice. We were born to deal with Esau and go back home. That's not gonna happen singing love songs. Okay, you understand that?
I knew that when I was born.
Okay, so I just want to talk about that in our last video. And as I said, we love you, though. You all don't think we love you. I don't like doing this. This is a part of our job.
I love it.
Well, and you know, we gotta talk to you a little bit, because we're trying to get you ready for the second Exodus, y'all. This is about to pop off regardless, and we want everybody to go. You understand? Okay.
It's my pleasure to do my job. Nigga.
So,
John Wick.
I want to go over the last video. We're done with that part. Are you done?
Yes, honey? I'm done. Okay. And the reason it's called John Wick is not because John Wick is so much of an evil killer. It's because motherfuckers trying to kill him.
Exactly. Thank you.
Every day.
Esau been murdering
every day
for 500 years. And these MFers is talking about, y'all curse. You're not saying, You know what? I'm done. We go back to lesson 12, part 3. We cover that. I think in lesson 5 we cover that. As far as how we talk, Jesus.
That's why the Wizard of Oz makes a lot of sense. The Scarecrow, ain't he the one needed a brain? Y'all so fucking scared you don't have no fucking brain because you're not following what we're telling you to do to get enlightened.
Right. We're not here to talk nice to Esau. Esau been whooping our behinds. Esau been whooping our behinds. Okay? We're not here to talk sweet in his ear. And we're not here to talk sweet to you because you all are so messed up, Jesus. They get the nerve to get upset and say, y'all yell.
I don't want to hear no one screaming at me.
Jesus.
Okay? It's worth you going to hell forever with your family forever because you don't want to hear someone screaming at you while you ain't talking about a goddamn thing that you can't even fucking fix on your fucking channel. And the person I'm talking to know the fuck I'm talking to. Because I've been trying to reach out to your stupid ass for a long time and I'm tired.
Yeah. Well, it's not just about going. I mean, they're gonna be right here. They want to be nice to Esau. Talk nice to Esau. They can stay here and die with him. Okay.
So amen.
We gonna move along. We say it's gonna be based.
That's gonna take. Cause like I said, I wanna get this over with so I can enjoy my day and look at my brand new house my shit.
We miss the nation. You know, we love. This is what we want to talk about. You know, in our last video, we were saying that, you know, we were giving you all some time to go over the lessons and learn, and you know, on what God is doing for our nation of people at this time. And so we do want you to know, you know, honey, you know, we haven't talked to them in almost 2 months. We here to touch base and to Right. It won't be too many more videos before
it's not. And the thing is, we haven't been on for 2 months, but we've been seeing a lot of y'all fucking up for 2 months, too.
Yeah. And some of them have been listening.
And some of them have been listening, and there has been a separation for some. But it's too many of you who don't deserve what's coming.
That's right. Yeah. That's why we had to make another video. They clowning out there, baby.
Yeah.
I don't know. We used to say it in the 90s, but they clowning out there, okay? They effing up. So, a lot of you not doing what we said. And one of the things we said CPT. You know, what's the name of the therapy that the Most High y'all said we use? Go back. This is the code part 2. So, this is the name of this video. The name of the video in the last lesson was the code part 1.
Yes.
And we said, the Most High y'all said we need what? CPT.
Mm-hmm.
Which is what? The therapy that we need. For our
they can look at the video. I'm not gonna repeat myself.
Right.
It's been posted up for 2 months, more than 2 months. You should be able to tell us. I'm not finna keep repeating myself when I got the shit documented for you to go back and listen to over and over again.
Right. So that it's a therapy that you need, which includes changing your thought process. Okay. And so we're not gonna repeat ourselves a lot, but we also in the last video we went over the Willie Lynch letter and how that's affecting our nation today. And so that's what we want to go over again today. We want to kind of do a quick recap before we go into the new information for this video. Okay, so honey,
yes,
do you have that, the Willie Lynch letter?
Yes.
I was saying in the last video how this is have infiltrated us as a nation, how we're brainwashed and how we're really lynched, and the demonic system that Esau implemented on our minds through the Willie Lynch letter. Now, if you look up the name Willie Lynch in the court records, it doesn't exist, because of course, like I said, Esau's trying to lie and say he never even did that. That's a lie. Go back to the code part 1. Okay, you got to go to the previous lesson or you'll be confused, because I'm picking it up right here. They just changed the name. Like I told you, we live in it. Of course it existed, okay? And not only did he give one speech in Virginia to a bunch of slave masters, he went around the world, because we scattered in all four corners of the earth, giving this training on how to condition our minds. We want to go over that a little bit, and then we're going to pick it up and take it and bring it on in for this video. Okay, honey.
Okay, this is the Willie Lynch. In my bag here.
This is Willie Lynch talking.
I have a foolproof method for controlling your black slaves. I guarantee every one of you that is installed, if it is installed correctly, it will control the slaves for at least 300 years.
You hear that? Remember I said in the last video, Willie Lynch was paid to go around through the South, Canada, Trinidad, Virgin Islands, to every place we were scattered where there were slaves, and to teach the evil slave owners how to condition the minds of the slaves. Go back to the code part 1. We go over that in more detail. And this is who he's talking to. He's talking to a crowd of people that he was paid to come and train.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Okay. Continuing. My method is simple, and members of your family and any overseer can use it. I have outlined a number of differences among the slaves.
You hear that? I've outlined a number of differences among the slaves. Now, mind you, everybody's slaves, but he's outlined a difference, mm-hmm. the differences among the slaves. Okay.
And I take these differences and make them bigger.
Can you repeat that one part?
I take these differences and make them bigger.
Catch that. I've outlined a difference among the slaves. They all slaves, but I've outlined differences among the slaves. This is the training that Esau was given to condition our minds. And among these differences, I've made them what?
Bigger.
Bigger. Okay. Keep that. We're coming back to that. Out of the little differences. Everybody's slaves.
Mm-hmm.
But I'm going to take the little differences among the slaves and make them what?
Bigger.
Bigger. Okay.
I use fear, distrust, and envy for control purposes. These methods have worked on my modest plantation in the West Indies. and it will work throughout the South. Mm-hmm. Take this simple little list of differences, think about them. On top of my list is age. But it is there only because it starts with an A. The second is color or shade.
Can you repeat that part?
The second is color or shade of black slaves.
That's right. One of these differences he's going to make bigger is color, shade of black. Everybody slaves.
Colorism.
But we're going to make difference between color. Man, you. Willie, this was planned.
That's why they put the light-skinned ones in the house and the darker ones was in the field. The house niggas, field niggas.
That's right.
They make the field niggas hate the house niggas and the house niggas be loyal to the master because I don't want to be in the field working and getting beat.
We getting on all that. Okay, keep going, honey.
There is intelligence, size, sex, size of plantation, status on plantation, attitude of owner, whether the slaves live in the valley, on the hill.
Wait, but honey, I'm going to cut you off right there. When it says that there is, whether the slaves live in the hill, that's the part. I'm sorry.
So it says, he goes by, there is intelligence, size, sex, size of plantation, status on plantation, attitude of owner. Here it is. Whether the slaves live in the valley, on the hill, east, west, north, south, have fine hair or coarse hair, or is tall or short.
Stop right there. When he said, when the slaves live in the valley and the hill, you have to understand, even among the slaves, our ancestors, there was a hierarchy. Mm-hmm. We're going to go into how I know that, okay? And you had the house Negroes. They were the top of that class. We're going to talk about the house Negroes, by the way. Then you had the town slaves, the town Negroes. Those are the ones that worked in Philadelphia, Boston, New York. Wasn't as hard. Mm-hmm. It was hard work, but it wasn't as hard as being out in the cotton fields, sugarcane fields. That's where you get the field slaves. So even among slaves, no one had nothing. There was a hierarchy. Mm-hmm. Esau put that in place. Okay, honey, keep going.
And that's where you get the boule stems from.
Yeah.
All for us, none for y'all attitude. Mm-mm-mm. Now that you have a list of differences, I shall give you an outline of action. But before that, I shall assure you that distrust is stronger than trust. Mm-hmm. And envy is stronger than adulation.
You hear that? He's saying you want them to distrust each other and envy each other. Be jealous. Okay?
Yep.
Be jealous of each other. Now, if you think about it, no other nation really does that. Yes, jealousy exists. But when other nations have politicians and celebrities, all they look to is like, okay, you're going to help the people in whatever platform you have. We get mad at those that become
Who become successful, exactly.
Okay, that's Willie Lynch. Okay, keep going, sweetheart.
Okay, so it said, distrust is stronger than trust, and envy is stronger than adulation, respect, or admiration. Mm-hmm. Continuing. The black slaves, after receiving this indoctrination, shall carry on and will become self-refueling and self-generating for hundreds of years, maybe thousands. Don't forget, you must pitch the old black versus the young black male and the young black male versus the old black male. You must use the dark-skinned slaves versus the light-skinned slaves and the light-skinned slaves versus the dark-skinned slaves. You must also have your white servants and overseers distrust all blacks. But it is necessary they trust and depend on us. They must love, respect, and trust only us.
That's right. So it's saying we must love, respect, and trust Esau.
Esau.
But distrust and hate each other. Okay. That's how they kept it going, and that's why you could have a one plantation overseer and one slave owner family, and they could have 50, 100 slaves and not get slaughtered, because that's what should have happened. But you have to keep everybody divided. Okay.
Gentlemen, these kits are your control. Use them.
This is his training.
Have your wives and children use them. Mm-hmm. Never miss an opportunity to use them. Mm-hmm. My plan is guaranteed. And the good thing about this plan is that if used intensely for 1 year, the slaves themselves will remain perpetually distrustful of each other.
Jeez, can you repeat that? Thank Jesus. Please repeat that last part. What did Willie Lynch say? That this Willie Lynch, that this plan, that this system that was printed, it was circulated worldwide against for all plantation owners, for all of Esau. One nation enslaved another. Esau enslaved Jacob. What was the training? What did he tell them in that last part that this training would do when he went around training the other evil slave masters how to condition our minds?
He said, my plan is guaranteed, and the good thing about this plan is that if used intensely for 1 year, the slaves themselves will remain perpetually distrustful of each other.
That's right. And his work.
And he ended it, thank you, gentlemen, Willie Lynch, 1712, the year.
And like I said, it has worked. And it's demonic.
Yeah.
We went over that in the last video. Like we said, the beast was given authority by yes. the devil. So if it sounds demonic, that's because it is.
Yes.
Okay? It doesn't take a rocket scientist to know that. You got to go to the very pits of hell to even come up with some stuff like this.
Yes.
And I'm going to say stuff. I won't hurt people.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm just laughing a little bit.
I'm laughing okay. on the inside.
So, we want to talk about this Willie Lynch letter. Now, that's what we read on our video part one for the code. We're talking about the code. Every nation have a code, and so do Hebrews. We have a code. And this code is detriment. It is very necessary for our second Exodus to be on code. Okay? So, I want to talk about, this brings me to my next part. I want to talk about some of this Willie Lynch letter that we didn't touch on the other parts. And like I said, the Most High y'all gave us this. Okay, it's not our opinion. And it says here, in one of the very first sentences, it says, don't forget to pitch the old black versus the young black. Okay, male. And it also says that you must also pitch male against female.
Yeah.
I want to talk about that, because that's what we would currently call today, just like we call the beast white supremacy when it's the beast in Revelation 12. We call the Willie Lynch, you must put male against female, female against male. We call that what? Gender war.
Gender war, yeah.
Currently. Okay, that's what's going on here. I want to talk about that. That brings me to my next point. This is what the Lord told us, that he trying to do a little bit cleanup. He's giving you all a little bit more. He's giving you all some time. That's why, like I said, we haven't been online to get you ready for the second Exodus. He that has an ear, let him hear. Some of you all have been listening. Some of you all have rejected it. Look, somebody got to die. 2/3 not going. But it's a little bit, almost half that are. So we're here to get you all ready to go back home. Okay, so we want to talk about this gender war, because this is very dear to his heart. He's not happy about what Esau did to us. And, you know, because you have these YouTubers like Chrissy and others, and most she's a female, but most of these are male, so-called black empowerment in this so-called conscious community.
Mm-hmm.
They have pushed a gender war among us for over 30 years.
Yeah.
Okay. And one of the tools that they use, and it's all Willie Lynch behavior. These supposed to be people that's conscious.
Yeah.
And for black empowerment, and they are indulging in Willie Lynch slave-minded behavior And I guess they don't know it. Do you think they know it?
They don't know it. And that's the sad part about it. Then when the prophets come and check you about the shit, you act like, who are we to listen to
they
you?
They get mad. Yeah, they get mad. Well, somebody
got Well, die. You got to stand. I'm not going to be in hell burning forever with you. So I already got my place.
Right. And the reason why my husband keep mentioning hell because for the second exit is if you're not going to Israel and daughter Babylon going to be new, then where the hell you going to be at? You're going to die.
Yeah.
And if you're not right with the Most High, y'all.
I let God do his job. I don't judge people. That's his job.
Get on code. That's why we have a whole video. This is part two. Get on code. And you'll be fine. Being on code simply means get on call with the second Exodus. We're going to go further into that, honey. Okay. So, they were one of the ones that perpetrated this mess. And you know, I hope I'm pronouncing her name right. I mentioned her in Black Empowerment, Why Black Empowerment Will Never Work, Lesson 6. Shaza Ali, I think that's her name. She's an older woman. She wasn't worthy of me fatting out her real name. But I think that's her name, Shaza Ali. You know, and this lie that she's been telling. And I went over in lesson 6 on how she's been perpetrating this lie. You know, she come from Farrakhan and their ilk.
Yeah.
And in order to have a seat at the table, she had to give the men what they wanted to hear. And she gladly did that. That's why she's a treasonous. Because she sold white women out. Hebrew women out for her own agenda. You know. Shaza Ali made over $1 million selling this crap. She sold a book saying that Hebrew women, black women, are the reason for the downfall of the black community because we accepted welfare and kicked all the men out the homes. And I went over that in great detail in lesson 6, okay? And, you know, that's a complete lie. Shaza Ali is at least 60. She's around the same age as my mother was when she passed away. She knows better. She knew it was a lie when she said it. Okay, no woman's going to kick her man out the house to get welfare. And what they failed to mention, I never take up for Esau. But one thing that I can say in all of this, as far as welfare and food stamps and Section 8, they do not kick husbands. Let me repeat that. As far as welfare, food stamps, and Section 8, they do not kick out husbands. They kick out boyfriends
and straggler men, just living you just laying up with.
That you laying up
having with. Babies by bastards.
But basically. She fixed it. They kicking men. They don't kick out husbands. They kicked out boyfriends. Okay, those men could have easily married those women.
Mm-hmm.
They did not split up families in that way, the government. If you were married, you still qualify for Section 8 as long as you fell under that income bracket.
Mm-hmm.
So that's a bunch of bull crap, and she knew it was a lie when she said it. Okay? They were saying that if you on Section 8 food stamps and welfare, some nigga can't be laying up in the house with you. Period.
Right.
Unless you marry.
Right.
So, they spilled this lie and they know damn well. Look it up for yourself. Don't take my word for it. Go look it up. Tell me the qualifications for food stamps, welfare, and Section 8 required you to be single and unmarried. Show it to me. I'll wait. They said a man can't be in the house. If you and your kids on the benefits, and he's not. And the only reason why he wouldn't be on the benefits if you weren't married. Does that make sense?
It makes perfect sense to me.
And they knew this. She knew this. This bitch knew this when she sold $1 million worth of books to spread this poison.
Through Farrakhan and that fucked up doctrine of fucking whatever the fuck it is.
On our people. And the black empowerment.
I just want to say this because I remember what you fucking said in April, motherfucker, talking about kill you, okay? You're going to get what the fuck you asked for.
Yeah. You know, he called himself Jesus.
You called yourself Jesus. Come kill me, then take my life. Motherfucker, I'm coming.
Well, he was one of the ones that pushed this heifer out here, spreading this poison, for 25, 30 years. She's not an elder. She's a cesspool. She knew it was a damn lie when she said it. She made over $1 million a book, and she got these black empowerment, so-called conscious community spreading this poison because she out here saying this mess, and no, it's a damn lie. Nothing about that is the truth, and that is what's been perpetrating this gender war for the last 40 years. Get out of here with that. Wow. That's some simple ABC basic. We shouldn't even have to come tell you that. Any fool. No wife would throw out her man so he could get well. She could get well.
You're repeating yourself. You did a whole lesson about this.
Lesson six.
That they could have went back and played it until they got it.
Lesson six. Yeah. So, but once again, the moral of our story is that is nothing but Willie Lynch, slave-minded behavior. That's all it is, because it's causing division. And what Shazia Lee has done is she's done nothing but engaged in treason. Treason is when she went against her own nation for her own agenda. She sold out black women so she could make $1 million, over $1 million, selling that garbage of a book. And it perpetrated the gender war. And they online repeating that mess as if they make sense.
It's truth. She's battling something solid.
Wow. And they even say, the movie Claudine shows that. We talking about, first of all, the woman, I looked that up. The movie Claudine was written by an old ass white couple. Jesus. And they saying it as if it's fact. Wow. Okay, moving right on. I'm gonna prove it to you. We gotta read Genesis chapter 3, verses 1-9, because we finna kill this gender war. Okay, because like I said, other nations, their men and their women, they make babies in love. We make babies, but we ain't making love among each other. Not gender wars. Okay, we're not each other's enemy. Esau taught you that you must put male against female, female against male. And this so-called conscious community has been perpetrating the very thing they claim to bring, they supposed to be helping us.
Deliverance from.
Blaming women. And making a bunch of beta males within our nation by excusing them of all responsibility. Really?
Then when an alpha male show up, these little... I ain't gonna go there.
Okay. But we're gonna go to Genesis chapter 3, verses 1 through 19. We're gonna make this real quick, and I'm gonna break this down real easy for you. But I'm gonna talk about our gender war and how it's the Hebrew woman's fault. For the state of the community's lie that the conscious community has been pushing for 30 years. It's complete order garbage. It's stupid. No woman is going to put her man out to get food stamps, that's paying the bills to get food stamps and welfare. Those were living boyfriends. And they could have easily married those women. And when the one woman put them out, they wouldn't stay with another. Mm-hmm. And we already talked about the bed bucking problem within our community. Okay, your Hebrew women is not your problem. Esau is your problem. Okay, honey. Genesis chapter 3, verse 1 through 19.
Under the heading, the fall. Now, the serpent was more crafty than any of the wild animals the Lord God had made. He said to the woman, did God really say you must not eat from any tree in the garden?
Okay, before he continue, I want to do a little background here. Everybody should know this story, but everybody doesn't know this story. We're talking about Adam and Eve, the fall of the first man, okay? And Adam and Eve were in the garden. They had been given everything they need. God was providing for them. And now they were cool. They were in the garden. You need to read the book of Adam and Eve. They were in this garden now for about 7 years at this point. Okay, and so now this is where this is being picked up in Genesis. So the serpent was more crafty than the other animals, and he came to Eve. Okay, honey, go ahead.
Verse 2. The woman said to the serpent, we may eat fruit from the trees in the garden, but God did say, you must not eat fruit from the tree that is in the middle of the garden, and you must not touch it, or you will die. You will not certainly die, the serpent said to the woman, for God knows that when you eat from it, your eyes will be opened, and you will be like God, knowing good and evil.
Mm-hmm. That's like the Illuminati. They want to be like God had it as Illuminati. Yeah. Okay, but he was saying that basically the serpent was telling Eve, oh, God didn't. You really not going to. He was trying to trick Eve. Okay, let's keep going.
When the woman saw that the fruit of the tree was good for food and pleasing to the eye and also desirable for gaining wisdom, she took some and ate it.
You hear that? I want us to catch that. It says right here, when the woman saw that the fruit of the tree was good for food and pleasing to the eye and also desirable for gaining wisdom, she took some and she ate it. Eve did it.
Mm-hmm.
Eve sinned first. Let's get that straight, man. I get it. Eve sinned first. Eve sat here and allowed the serpent to deceive her. She talked to him. She entertained him.
Mm-hmm.
And she let... He was saying, oh, you're not going to die from eating that. And Eve allowed herself to be deceived.
Mm-hmm.
And she took from that tree and she ate it. Did she not?
Yes, she did.
Does the word not say that? Eve did that. Eve committed the first sin in the history of humanity. Eve!
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we get. I understand that, man. Let's go.
She also gave some to her husband who was with her, and he ate it.
Wow. Then after she sinned, she took it and gave it to her husband,
mm-hmm.
and he ate it.
Mm-hmm.
So Eve allowed herself to be deceived by the serpent, sinned for the very first time. She committed the first sin in the history of humanity, and then turned to her husband and said, now you sin with me.
Mm-hmm.
Basically, right?
Basically.
Okay, and what did he say Adam did? He took out the fruit.
He took out the fruit and he ate it.
Because he knew she was in trouble. And he didn't want to be in trouble by himself. But yet, that's neither here or there. He went on and did it. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Then the eyes of both of them were opened. And they realized they were naked. So they sewed fig leaves together and made coverings for themselves.
Now their eyes are open. They know that they're naked. They make covering for themselves. Now, before you go to this next next verse, you need to understand, before the fall of man, like I tell you, I have visions and dreams. So does my husband. God comes sometime and talk to us face to face. Before the fall of man, the Lord came down and talked to Adam all the time, you know. And so this is what, now he used to come and talk to him every day in the cool of the day. So this is where verse 8 picks up. They have sinned. Now they covered themselves with fig leaves. And now what happens in verse 8?
Then the man and his wife heard the sound of the Lord God as he was walking in the garden in the cool of the day. And they hid from the Lord God among the trees of the garden.
They heard God coming and talk to them. Like we would call it dusk dark.
Right.
To come and talk to them like he did every day.
Mm-hmm.
And they hid from him because they had eaten his fruit. They had sinned by now. Okay, this is very important. What does verse 9 say?
Verse 9 says, but the Lord God called to the man, where are you?
Mm.
He answered, I heard you in the garden, and I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid.
Okay, let's stop right there. We're going to be here for just a minute. You see that? Verse 9. I want to take this back. Listen up, my Hebrew man. We love you. Eve was deceived first. I went over this in lesson 6. I'm going to go back over real quick. Eve was deceived first. Eve took that fruit and she ate it first.
Mm-hmm.
She basically committed the first sin of humanity first. Eve did that. Okay. Then she took it and offered it to her husband, causing him. He did it.
Mm-hmm.
That was a choice that he made because he didn't want to be separated from him, but he did it. But when God came down for an explanation, now mind you, he predicted our second exodus over 2,000 years ago. He predicted the death of Jesus. He predicted the coming of the Holy Spirit. He predicted our first exodus.
Mm-hmm.
So he knew who sinned first, who was deceived first, which was who?
Eve.
But when he came down for an explanation, who did he call? Can you read verse 9 again?
But the Lord God called to the man, where are you?
He called to the man. Looked like he should have been calling Eve.
Mm-hmm.
She the one did it.
Mm-hmm.
She sinned first. Why are you calling Adam? Wow. And so he answered and said, "And I was hidden in the garden. I was afraid because I was naked, so I hid." What does it say in verse 11?
"And he said, who told you that you were naked? Have you eaten from the tree that I commanded you not to eat from?"
Okay, stop right there. Do you understand that? He said, who asked you to eat from the tree that I commanded you not to eat from? Because he gave the instructions to Adam.
Mm-hmm.
And then Adam gave the instructions to Eve, which she had followed for 7 years. But then when she sinned, and didn't listen, and then gave it to him and caused him to sin. Okay, so what does verse 12 say Adam said?
"The man said, the woman you put here with me, she gave me some fruit from the tree and I ate it."
There you go. Because that sounds like our Hebrew men today.
Right.
The women. The women. Let's be very clear. Let's go back to verse 9. When God first came down, he knew who sinned first. He knew who was deceived first. It was Eve. But when he came down in verse 9 and to talk to them in the cool of the day like he did every day, he knew they were in trouble. And it said, but the Lord God called to the man, "Where are you?" It seemed like he should have been calling Eve because she the one sinned. But who did God hold responsible?
Adam, the man.
Adam. In the book of Adam and Eve, he said, "The woman I put you charge over. What happened?" That's what he said. That's who he called. What's the moral of my story right here? Women are not responsible for the state of leading. Cut the crap, Hebrew men. And Shazai Ali, she can go to the pit of hell where she came from with that bull crap. Women are not responsible for the... Women are not held in leadership roles. It didn't cut it with God then, and it doesn't fly with him now. He knew very well who sinned first and who was deceived first. But when he came down for an explanation in Genesis, it said the Lord, the King James Version said, the Lord God called to the man, "Adam, where are you?" In the book of Adam and Eve, he said, "What happened with the woman I put you charge over?" Okay, he held Adam responsible, not Eve. Cut the crap, okay? I went over this before. Stop it, Hebrew men. Women are not responsible for the state of leading. If you have a problem with that, take that up with the Most High Yah. This is his book,
not ours. And women are not responsible for taking care of your lazy asses either. Now, I ain't saying that a woman can't make more money than you in a marriage relationship. But what I'm saying, you pimp motherfuckers with those mentalities. A woman is not your fucking bread. Is not your fucking bread basket.
And that all comes back, go back to Willie Lynch, okay? That all goes back to how our men were made to breed and not take care of their children.
Yes.
Okay? And see, they want to sit up and blame the welfare system. You need to be blaming Esau, but they don't want to do that.
Because they're scared.
Yeah, because that would take some spine. But we love you. We working on you, okay? So we're not going to read the whole thing. We're going to go over 12. I'm going to summarize and I'll tell you where to pick up. So it says, then the man said to the woman, he blamed the woman and said, "The woman you gave to me, did that fly with God?"
No.
It didn't fly with him at all. Because when you go down here to verse 17, he got Adam real good.
Mm-hmm.
Now to Eve, he just said, "Why you do that?" And then he gave her curse.
Mm-hmm.
But to Adam, he gave him a whole speech before he gave him his curse. He said, "I want to know why you're about to get this work, because the woman I put you charge over, what happened?" That's why he called them first. That's who he called. I don't know where our Hebrew men get where they think they can blame the black empowerment, conscious community, think they can sit up and blame women for the state of our community.
Right. When they the ones off their fucking post.
And how are you doing that? By not getting married, by not valuing marriage. You date to have sex. You don't date to marry.
Yes.
Okay. And then you want to blame the woman because that's a lot easier than dealing with who?
The enemy.
Esau. Okay. Okay. You want to talk about welfare and food stamps? Talk about why the hell Esau not hammering y'all to work. Once you talk, that should never they be talking about. They would need welfare and food stamps, but you don't want to do that. It's easier to blame the weaker vessel. Gee, it didn't fly with God then. It's not flying with him now, Hebrew man. I know we in our land of captivity, but this gender war, that shit over with. Okay, you don't blame your women.
Hell, colorism is over. I better not hear another motherfucking woman talking about light skin versus dark skin shit.
We definitely getting on that. I'm coming down.
You're a fucking woman. That's period. If you're light skin shade, you're darker shade, or you're a caramel shade, you're a fucking Hebrew woman. Period. Right. Ain't no fucking color.
Yeah.
I bet not hear no motherfucking videos about colorism. Going you young 25-ish. What's that?
We're actually gonna get on that more.
Yeah,
I'm saying. But yeah, that's been it's disgusting. It's Willie Lynch slave man behavior, and you're right. And that's what we're gonna get to, because that's what we were talking about. This gender war that's going on, men, you need to understand, women are not responsible for the state of leading. You lead and the women will follow. That is how it goes. And I'm gonna prove that's how it goes, because even in black empowerment, all this foolishness they pulling, the women falling right in line over that mess, and it's stupid. But you're right, honey. That's what we're going to, because I need you to listen up, women of Judah. While you sitting up here talking about colorism, like my husband was saying, you know, light skin, dark skin, and like I said, the dark skin women are perpetrating it more at this time.
Yes.
At one point in our history, the light skin women were perpetrating it more back in the 1800s, early 1900s. But now it's the dark skin women. And like we said in the last video, I know that you have been traumatized by this beast, and people have been giving you all a bad name because of your beautiful, darkly melanated skin. But that does not give you, we all been traumatized by this beast. It does not give you the right to keep up this Willie Lynch, slave-minded divisiveness. Okay? And they love to say dark-skinned women. And like I said, there are more Hebrew women than dark-skinned women. You have, and light-skinned women, you also have the in-between, the caramel
yes.
and the peanut butter complexion. I fall into that category. I talked about that last video. So, while you sitting up here talking about colorism, we coming for it. And natural hair vlogs, okay? Give me a minute, babe, because let me take a drink here of lemonade.
Yeah, say that, because they might say the prophets are getting drunk while they doing their videos.
Oh, jeez.
It's lemonade.
Right, we already not say. Okay, so Esau's women, okay, they have just armed these bitches with guns against our kids. Texas, Florida. They using the mass shootings that Esau kids come and do as a reason to arm these low-down, dirty Esau bitches with guns, because 90% of the education force, as far as teachers, is what?
Esau women.
And they giving them guns.
And in the classroom to teach our kids.
Over your kids, you women of Judah. Really? Okay, they don't shoot their kids, mass shootings. They come and kill 20 kids in the school and they'll take them out alive. But now all of a sudden, they over our children and now they need guns. And this is historical. They have killed our babies since the plantation. Like I said, they had to come out with a law to protect those bitches from killing our kids. And these Hebrew women are sitting their asses on land talking about the shade we are and freaking natural and weed. When you got these bitches over our kids with guns, are you serious? That's your enemy. Esau women, not your own women. They Willie lynched.
Yeah.
Slave man.
Well, you know what? They Willie lynched. So you know what happened to Hebrews as Willie lynched? They just get fucking lynched. We do hanging suit.
98% of the 911 calls that they've been trying to get on the last 2 years, because they caught the dog whistle that the police are killing Hebrews now. So 98% of those calls going out now are by Esau's women. These Esau bitches are trying to get our husbands, our brothers, our nephews, and our children killed. While y'all engaging in plantation fights. What about these bitches? I'm not hearing nothing. What about Esau bitches? I'm not hearing nothing. Crickets.
Yeah.
Do we have anything to say about these bitches calling the police on our men and children?
They're really show off their fucking bodies in tight fucking clothes on their fucking YouTube channel that's getting hundreds of thousands of hits instead of leading somebody to some salvation or some kind of remedy. You're too busy talking about hair weave and natural and straight, and you're talking about the colorism bullshit when we at fucking war.
They just aren't these Esau devils with guns, these women. But see, they don't want to deal with
it. But
are you a woman or not?
But then when something terrible happens at a convenience store or a Waffle House, y'all motherfuckers act like y'all shocked. Like, where's all this come from? It's always been here. It's always been around you.
No, they too busy talking about natural hair, weed, the dark skin, our men, attacking our men. When you got plenty of Esau bitches to deal with, you women of Judah. I'm talking to the women. It's disgusting. It's Willie Lynch slave manner behavior. Listen up. Heaven hair campaigns. Okay? We already know we got them beat in the hair. Listen up. Our lips, women of Judah. Listen to me. I'm trying to talk to you. Okay? I know I'm getting a little upset because the slave man, once you get the Willie Lynch off of you through CPT, changing your thought process, you get kind of impatient with those that refuse to do that. You need to listen, women of Judah. Our lips, our hips, we already got the versatile hair that we have. Esau women age like bananas. We don't need to prove anything about our appearance to these women. You need to be focused on how they're trying to kill our kids, you women of Judah.
They the ones getting a tanning thing to look like you.
You. Confident women do not go around explaining their confidence. I'm going to repeat that. Confident women do not go around explaining their confidence. Okay? When you get a woman that trying to explain her confidence, that's not confidence, you women of Judah. That is trying to prove something, which equals low self-esteem.
Insecurity.
Willie Lynch is what it is. Listen, because what you're really saying is, Esau, see her hair? It's beautiful too. Please acknowledge that. I'm going to say that again. Esau, see our hair. See our natural hair. It's beautiful too. Please acknowledge that.
I don't see how when you naturally get licensed shit.
But that's what I'm saying. Teen girls go around talking about hair and makeup. Not grown ass women. Well, you women of Judah.
Yeah.
I'm going to repeat that one more time because I'm getting upset. I'm trying not to. Sometimes I got to hit my Bible so I can calm down. Teen girls go around talking about hair and makeup. Not grown women. All these natural hair vlogs. Like that's bringing them liberation. Oh, I've learned to embrace my natural. What the hell is that going to do for the police shooting us?
Nothing.
How about let's talk about Esau dealing with these evil Esau bitches that's trying to kill our kids since the foundation of white supremacy. And going back home. What the hell is natural hair going to do? How is that liberation?
Planned Parenthood was started off the basis of the best way to kill a nigga is before they even born. That's abortion.
You need to be dealing with that. Not, please accept our hair, Esau. We love our hair. Our hair is beautiful, too. I don't need to stop the explaining about why do, only Willie Lynch slave man to people would need a movement. Right, for hair. What the hell? For hair? It's what grow out our hair, it's natural, it's beautiful, it's versatile. Next point, let's move on. Let's deal with these Esau bitches trying to kill our kids. How's that?
And I'm not going to change. I'm not going to perm my hair to work for your stupid ass Esau. So that's the attitude you need to always have. If you can't deal with my natural beautiful hair, then fuck it, I ain't going to work here. And then you get told no enough, then you should get to the point where, you know what, fuck it. I'm going to start my own shit, make my own money where I can tell you to go kick fucking rocks.
That's liberation, not we love our hair. Oh, we love our hair. What is that doing? Y'all sound silly. Real women don't sit up and talk about hair and makeup. Teen girls do. Okay, you women of Judah? The natural hair movement is a joke. It's not doing a damn thing. Okay? That's what grow out your head. And it should be kept nice. And yes, women should be should maximize their beauty. I see nothing wrong with that. But see, having it as a movement against for liberation, how is that liberating?
It's not all it does is
plantation fight.
And then it also put both sides of the argument, the Willie Lynch argument, in direct line of fire. Like I said, it's a list.
Fine hair, coarse hair. It's not doing nothing. They want to sit up and act like they actually own something because they have natural hair. Really? What is that? Okay, so when Esau come, a cop come with a gun to shoot you or your daughter or your son, they not going to shoot because their son has dreads? Are they not going to shoot because your daughter have Afro puffs? Are they not going to shoot because you wearing braids?
Hell, they shoot even if they had a Caesar with waves.
Nope. Exactly.
They was shooting us when we wasn't wearing growing our hair and dreads and braids back
then. So what the hell does that have to do with what we dealing with as a nation, which was dealing with Esau and getting back home? Okay, your fellow Hebrew sisters are not your enemy. Esau, those bitches, that's your enemy. Understand that and never forget it. And they after your kids and your men. They always have been. Do you understand Esau women attack our men? Hell, more than the men do.
Yeah.
He raped me trying to get our men killed. And y'all talking about natural hair. Jesus. Today I'm going to close it up with this hair. We're going to do, because see, y'all got the game messed up.
They got the game real fucked up.
Jesus. Okay. We're going to deal with this hair thing one more time. We're going to put this thing to bed because, see, we need real women to go back to Israel. We don't need little girls talking about hair and makeup. There's nothing wrong with hair and makeup. I wear that. I love it. Okay? But that's not,
I do want to say this because it's going to touch the person who needs to hear this. And at this time, it ain't about the clothes on you that you fucking wearing. Mm-hmm. Because at the end of the day, you ain't never led no one directly to me. Mm-hmm. So you can talk about the clothes, the high heel shoes, all that bullshit, but you ain't never sent a soul to me.
To the message.
To the message.
Yeah.
When I say me, that's what I mean. Me, message.
Mm-hmm. Now the second Exodus.
And if you don't do your job, how the hell am I supposed to reach them? If no one else is doing their part.
We want to talk about this hair thing one last. I'm talking to my women of Judah because y'all run around talking about nothing because they don't have an agenda.
And another thing I want to say, and because we own the women, quit going to other people's channels and trying to get a message that you don't even understand the meaning behind what they're talking about. They're versed in numbers. You're not. Shut the hell up. Mm-hmm. That ain't your lane. Don't speak on it.
You know, some people, because it's something they don't understand, they just assume.
It's new age.
Right.
It's,
these are people who never even read the Apocrypha. They think that's the devil.
Yeah.
When that's the other 100 books of the Bible. But yet they're trying to tell you about Jesus.
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, you righteous ones, this is not the time or the hour to be playing around.
To be a Pharisee, because that way you're so stuck on what you think you know.
Traditionalists.
Okay. He doing a new thing. He said it for the second Exodus. Read Isaiah 40 through 50. Okay. All right. So we're going to put this hair thing to rest here. I want to break this down a little bit. God has something specifically for our hair. He knew how petty his women would be. But I want to break this down a little bit. Honey, you got Isaiah chapter 3, verse 16, and I don't understand why this right here in the Bible, I don't understand why they didn't see it. You understand?
Isaiah chapter 3, verse 16.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. You ready?
I am.
The Lord says, the women of Zion are haughty, walking along with outstretched necks, flirting with their eyes, strutting along with swaying hips, with ornaments jingling on their ankles.
Okay, let me do a little background here. This is for our ancestors, Okay. And for one thing, I want you all to understand, you, a lot of you all get this scripture twisted. We're going to go further into the scripture. God is not talking about he doesn't want women to wear makeup or jewelry. Okay. What he's saying right here, and we're about to go a little further. What he's saying right here is, by this time, women of Judah, our people had turned against the Most High Yah. We weren't serving him. We had turned, and he had, at this time, other nations were jealous of us because we were so blessed. We won all the wars.
Mm-hmm.
We won, we had all the wealth. We had all the gold. And he's saying, I blessed you, and now you're walking around haughty and forgot me as if I didn't do this for you.
Yes.
See, you got to understand, our women, our ancestors were very wealthy and prosperous. We had the finest gold and jewels, and we were beautiful. You understand? And so we were admired by other nations. And so, but instead of being grateful, our ancestors, okay, virgin Israel, they got haughty. That's why he said, y'all being haughty. You walking around, flirting with your ass, swaying your hips. And what else is he saying about them in verse 17? Wait,
before I go there, I'm gonna take that, what you just said, a little bit deeper. Have you all have heard the saying, it's God that makes you a star.
Mm-hmm.
That's why some bombs never go off and some stars never blow up. Yes. Meaning, you can have all the talent in the world, but it's God who has to touch you to make your talent become successful, for you to be a billionaire, for you to be successful in any industry. So what I'm saying, when you become that star, you forget God. And then you're getting all these accolades and awards and all this fake money, and you forget God, and he like, what the fuck? I'm the one who brought that for you.
That's what happened to our women of Judah, and this was their punishment. Okay, so what does he say in verse 17, honey? You right.
Therefore, the Lord will bring sores on the heads of the women of Zion. The Lord will make their scalps bald.
Wow, listen to that. Because a lot of people misinterpreted the scripture. The Most High Yah was so mad at our ancestors for them turning away against him. He said, I blessed you with all that wealth. Remember Solomon's gold? Go back to lesson 12, part 1. I made you a nation that's feared by all nations. And now you want to walk around here like you all that. Our ancestors pissed them off so bad. He said, I'm going to make y'all bald. The women going to be bald. Y'all think y'all so pretty. Let me explain the scripture to you, okay? Let me break this down. Listen up, my women of Judah. All women over every nation, hair grows either mid-back or waist length. Even the Ethiopians,
mm-hmm.
their hair is long, it's beautiful and thick. You know, there's another tribe in Africa where all their hair grows butt length.
Mm-hmm.
If you think about it, every nation of woman, the natural growth of their hair is either mid-back or waist length.
Mm-hmm.
Hebrew women are the only women that our hair don't grow back length or waist length.
Naturally.
Think about that. He loved us so much, he said he didn't make us completely bald, but we have the shortest length of hair among all other women in all nations, and this is why. He says, therefore the Lord will bring sores on the heads of the women of Zion. The Lord will make their scalps bald. That is what that scripture means. Now, we have a small 1-2% who can actually grow their hair mm-hmm. waist length. Like, we have a small 1-2% that's actually wealthy.
Mm-hmm.
But as a group, all my life I've been told, oh, your hair's so long and pretty. Listen, my hair grows shoulder length. Don't it, honey? Mm-hmm. Shoulder length. Now, there's nothing. Everybody else, all other nation women hair grow mid. And yeah, I was told my whole life, you have long hair. Because for black women, let's just be real. Let's keep it real. Stop all the bull crap. Hey, everybody can grow their hair. No, you know dang on well, as a group, Hebrew women hair only grow, it don't grow mid back or waist length like all other nations.
And that's the reason you buy weaves, because you want to feel like you, like what should be naturally occurring, your hair should be growing all the way to your ass, mm-hmm. but it doesn't because of the sin nature of that's within our ancestors. So now you go and buy weave to make it seem and appear that you got this long goddess type hair.
That's a part of our curse. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Okay, so if you want to know why our hair don't grow as long as other women, that's why. That's why. It's right here. Okay? That's why. He's going to make your hair shorter. your hair gonna be shorter than all other women. You think you all that. That's a part of the curse. Now, for the last 10 years, a lot of our women hair have been growing longer because it's time for that curse to lift.
To lift, exactly.
And that's what you've been seeing, even with the natural hair movement, and a lot of us are getting longer hair than we've ever had before. That's because the curse in Israel is gonna be down to our waist. It's going back to what it was. We were naturally created to be. But as a result of the curse, women. It's right here. It's clear as day in your face. I don't see how people misinterpret this scripture.
Because they don't read the scripture. They get it from false teachers, false prophets, traditional churches.
And go ahead and finish reading verses 18 through 26. Because we started out with, therefore the Lord will bring sores on the heads of the women of Zion. The Lord will make their scalps bald.
Okay. Verse 18 continues. In that day, the Lord will snatch away their finery, the bangles and headbands and crescent necklaces, the earrings and bracelets and veils, the headdresses and anklets and sashes, the perfume bottles and charms, the signet rings and nose rings, the fine robes and the capes and cloaks, the purses and mirrors, and the linen garments, and tiaras, and shawls.
There you go. Basically, you know how now we've seen this ancient mamas.
Mm-hmm.
You okay? And mammies.
Mm-hmm.
We were so wealthy and rich and beautiful with all adorning all our jewelry and gold. He said, I'm going to take all that away. Y'all going to be bald head. Y'all going to have less head than anybody. That's how mad we made him. You made him really mad. Anytime he put you in the belly of the beast and the hands of Esau, and these y'all make y'all bald headed. That means because our Hebrew women were known for being beautiful. Mm-hmm. Of course, we're the most high nation. Of course, we were going to be beautiful. We still are. But he took all that away. We got to wear weed to get the lint that we normally used to have. Thank our ancestors for that. Okay? But it's almost over. But it is
over. It is over.
Okay, keep reading, honey.
Instead of fragrance, there will be a stench. Instead of a sash, a rope.
Being hung.
Instead of well-dressed hair, baldness.
Yeah.
Instead of fine clothing, sackcloth.
Slave clothing.
Mm-hmm. Instead of beauty, branding.
Branding, when we were branded as slaves. Mm-hmm.
Your men will fall by the sword, your warriors in battle.
You hear that? We were so confident in our men because we won war. See, we can't relate to that now because we're like, our men are scared. No, our men, the women of Judah were so calm because our men didn't lose
right
back then. And he said, your men going to fall by the sword, your warriors in battle. And he said, I'm going to make your men weak, basically, right?
Yeah, basically.
And part of the curse. Okay, finish it up.
And verse 26 concludes, the gates of Zion will lament and mourn. Destitute, she will sit on the ground.
That's what happened to our ancestors. Okay, and that's what they did, and that's part of the curse. So that's what I'm saying, all this natural hair, that's the problem with our hair. That's why our hair don't grow as long as other nations of women. Okay, so now we going into our next part. We want to revisit this colorism bullcrap, okay, which my husband was talking about earlier in the video. And we so sick of it. And see, when we say we sick of something, I don't think they understand the danger in just going against the code at this time.
Mm-mm.
But we're going to deal with this because we love you. Okay? You willing to enslave Mandy, abuser of your own people. We're going to deal with this colorism. Listen up. Bae.
Yes.
I need you to turn to Deuteronomy chapter 28. Deuteronomy 28, which is a lot of these reprobate atheists, they say, oh, they believe in Deuteronomy 28. Well, that describes the state of our nation at this time. Deuteronomy 28 was written in 609 BC. Okay. And so we didn't start getting that work from Deuteronomy 28 to over 1,000 years later. Actually, 1,100 years later.
Mm-hmm.
But it was the Most High Yah predicting what would happen to the state of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, we're going to go further into that. But I want you to know that Deuteronomy 28 said this is what will happen to Israel, meaning Israelites, Hebrews. Okay, Israel is where we're from. That's why we call Israelites.
Mm-hmm.
And Hebrews is our nationality. We're going to get more into that.
Mm-hmm.
Because you all need help, Jesus.
They, like I said earlier, they need more than help. They need a heart.
CBT.
The cowardly Conan lion. They need a brain. That's the scarecrow. They need... what was it? The lion needed the brain. The scarecrow needed the heart.
No, the scarecrow needed the brain.
Okay, the lion needed the heart.
Courage.
Courage.
The lion needed courage, and the tin man needed the heart.
Okay.
Our people don't have none of that.
Nah. It's in wrong places in their body.
And then they had another trying to come to correct us. Right. Okay. Well, okay. So now we're gonna
and that's what it's all about. We're trying to get everyone in balance, perfect balance, so you're in your right frame of mind, you got the right spirit.
CBT.
So we can get this, help you get this done, because like I said, our part, my wife and I and a lot of other people, we're already on that level. We're trying to bring you guys up to the level so you won't be afflicted with the people left behind.
They think they on that level. They don't know that. You know what? Y'all need a big dose of humility. Yeah. You really do.
And this verse that I'm finna read is gonna give you a big dose of humility, quick, fast. Cause mm-hmm. like I said, at the snap of a finger, your ass will be in that sunken place.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
But we love you. I always say that they don't understand how much we love. That's why we go through this. Are you serious?
Yeah, that's why.
You have to have a love for your people to deal with these people.
Yeah, I swear. Jesus Christ. Like we taking all these licks, fending off demonic attacks, trying to rescue y'all, and then you still ain't even appreciative. You still do the opposite of what we tell you to do.
But there's a remnant.
Yeah.
That's going to do what we say. And that's doing what we say. And that's who going.
And that's what we hear.
Somebody got to die in the 2/3.
Exactly.
Okay. So we're gonna go to Deuteronomy chapter 28.
I'm going to read Deuteronomy 28, verses 28 and 29. It gives you a better scope of what we're talking about.
Yeah, I'm going to do a little background after you read 29, honey.
Okay.
Okay.
Okay, verse 28. The Lord will afflict you with madness, blindness, and confusion of mind.
Mm-mm-mm.
Verse 29 continues. At midday, you will grope about like a blind person in the dark. You will be unsuccessful in everything you do.
Okay. This is, and I'm glad you read both, like you said, this is what Moses prophesied. What happened to us 1,100 years before it actually happened. Wait, it was written in 609, which was actually 2,628 years ago. Okay? And Moses, the Lord had given to Moses what happened to Israel. You know, and that we would eventually, as a nation, virgin Israel, would turn against God. And mm-hmm. so he was telling us the curses that would come upon us as a result of not staying faithful to the God who had brought us out and blessed us with so much prosperity and made us his chosen people. Moses was predicting the consequences, the curses that will come upon the nation of Israel, which is virgin Israel, not daughter Zion. We're daughter Zion, for not staying the course.
Or the way of the Lord, the way of God. Lord. Okay. Living true and living God.
Not to mention our ancestors killed Jesus
mm-hmm.
and so many prophets before him.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, on that, daughter Zion, our ancestors
and
did.
Hell, we can say even after him.
Yeah. Yep. Okay.
Okay, so continuing. Day after day, you will be oppressed and robbed.
Wait, I'm sorry. Before you say that, when you say after them, you're talking about Martin Luther King.
I'm talking about that of the our other leaders, from the Marcus Garveys, the Martin Luther King, who was trying to progress us further. They were all martyred.
Coons. Well, Marcus Garvey wasn't killed. He was sent back to
Jamaica. Well, the same thing. But they removed the voice.
Mm-hmm.
So
our people.
Right. They removed the
Martin
voice.
Martin Luther King couldn't have been killed. Malcolm X couldn't have been killed without Hebrews. aligning themselves with Esau.
Exactly.
Disgusting as a nation. Just disgusting. And I don't know why they love their oppressors so
again,
much.
And again, let me repeat that. Day after day, you will be oppressed and robbed with no one to rescue you.
Okay, so let's start with, I'm sorry, babe. Let's start with Deuteronomy 28, verse 37.
Verse 37. You will become a thing of horror, a byword, and an object of ridicule among all the peoples where the Lord will drive you.
Okay, let's stop right there. We're going to be here just a quick minute. You will become a thing of horror. Okay. A byword. Can somebody say nigger? N-I-G-G-E-R.
Or N-I-G-G-A, even though we gave that to ourselves.
Right. But that's our.
That's ours. We turn nigger into something
so
positive. So it's endearment.
It's the E-R.
Right.
You will become a thing of horror. I fear for my life.
Mm-hmm.
I saw a black guy.
Mm-hmm.
I'm scared. Okay.
They're barbecuing the police.
Yeah. Black people. They're scary. Okay. A byword and an object of your ridicule. Nigger. Can you say N-I-G-G-E-R again? Mm-hmm. Among all the peoples where the Lord would drive you. That means among Latinos.
Mm-hmm.
Asians.
Mm-hmm.
Arabians. That's why we have no allies.
Mm-hmm.
Because it says in another scripture that you have no allies.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so let me repeat that. You will become a... He's saying this is what's going to happen to Israel. Moses predicted this 2,600 years before it actually happened. And it was 1,100 years ago before we came into captivity. And these people had a nerve to think, the Bible is a fairy tale.
It's the greatest story ever told.
Yeah, it seemed real to me.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. You will become a thing of horror, nigger. A byword. That's nigger.
That's a byword, yeah.
A thing of horror. I fear for my life. We're crime infested. Okay. And an object of ridicule. Every nation make fun of us. All the peoples where the Lord will drive you. This is part of our curse. Do you understand? Okay, honey. If you could read, jump down to chapter 28, verses 45 through 46. He's talking about Israel, Israelites, and what would happen. Moses predicted what would happen to us 2,600 years before it actually happened, because he knew that virgin Israel, our ancestors, would turn against the Most High Yah after he blessed them with gold and silver and winning in war and setting them upon high. They would forget about him. And he said, as a result of that, this is what's going to happen to Israel. And we're the result of that, daughter Zion. Do they get it? Does that make sense?
It made perfect sense to me. I don't see why they don't get it.
They don't want to. We're going to keep on. Okay, so what is chapter Deuteronomy 28, verses 45 to 46 say? He said, this is how you'll know you my people.
All these curses will come on you. They will pursue you and overtake you until you are destroyed.
Pursue you and overtake you until you are destroyed. We have the lowest self-esteem on the face of the planet as a nation. Okay.
Because you did not obey the Lord your God and observe the commands and decrees he gave you. Verse 46. They will be a sign and a wonder to you and your descendants forever.
Stop right there. Keep that. I want you to keep that. We're coming back to that, my people. They will be a sign and a wonder to you and your descendants forever. Okay, let's keep that. We're going to keep 46. Keep going, babe. 47.
Because you did not serve the Lord your God joyfully and gladly in the time of prosperity.
Stop that. You understand, for all you reprobate atheists that's mad that God punished us. When God, he said, because you didn't serve me joyfully and gladly in your time of prosperity. He gave our ancestors plenty of prosperity,
joy, happiness, love.
And we couldn't handle it. We got full of ourselves because other nations, we didn't do that, daughter Zion, but our ancestors did. Forgot him. Okay, and killed his son, by mm-hmm. the way. Okay, keep going, honey.
Therefore, in hunger and thirst, in nakedness, in dire poverty, you will serve the enemies the Lord sends against you.
Esau.
He will put an iron yoke on your neck until he has destroyed you.
Slavery.
49. The Lord The Lord will bring a nation against you from a far away, from the ends of the earth, like an eagle swooping down, a nation whose language you will not understand, a fierce-looking nation without respect for the old or pity for the young.
Okay. And we all know when he says here, the Lord bring against you a nation from far away, from the ends of the earth, like an eagle swooping down. At some point, all European nations, not just America, had the eagle as a symbol for their nation. Mm-hmm. That was the hints he was throwing to us. What Deuteronomy 28 is basically is saying, Moses, 2,600 years ago, predicted that this was going to happen to Israel as a result of our of virgin Israel's disobedience, that we would be cursed.
Mm-hmm.
And that we would be living in the belly of the beast, Revelation 12, which is what you call white supremacy, for 500 years as a result of that. That we were going to go into slavery. We were going to be a byword, nigger.
And,
okay.
And the way I look
and
at it.
And a thing of horror.
The way I look at it is also, you can also look at it as you'll be living in a hell on earth.
Yeah. And we have been.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, he said you won't have assurance of your life. You don't never know. We don't, in slavery, they didn't have assurance mm-hmm. of their life. In Jim Crow, we didn't have assurance of our mm-hmm. life. And even now, being shot by the police, there's no assurance of our life. Mm-hmm. That's also part of the curse. Okay. And so you need to understand, this is the part I want to go to. Okay. Part 46. Verse 46. They read, can you read that again? 28:46, because I'm going somewhere here.
They will be a sign and a wonder to you and your descendants forever.
There we go. I'm hitting my Bible again because I need you to get it. They will be a sign and wonder to you and your descendants forever. Okay. Let me explain that to you, because you don't get it. That means nobody on the planet is going to be treated the way you are. Nobody on the face of the planet is going to be treated the way my people are. So in 500 years, when I arouse and awaken them, when they know who they truly are, how are they going to know they're my nation?
By the way you're treated.
By the way we're treated. Catch that. They will be a sign and a wonder to you and your descendants forever. That means nobody on the face of the planet gonna be treated like you. That's how you'll know if you're a Hebrew Israelite. You get it?
I get it.
We're coming back to that because I
but we got some out there who always wanna throw a little dart. When they're talking about when they have they operating Willie Lynch, self-proclaimed Hebrew
yeah,
Israelite.
We don't get on that self-proclaimed. Shit. I'm so mad, babe. We coming for it. Really?
You can't be self-proclaimed. Something can't be self-proclaimed when it's just it is.
It is. And I want to call her a bitch, but I'm not going to do that because she's younger. I'm going to deal with the babies. I'm going to deal with the children. Okay, I'm going to do that. I'm being a little nicer. I'm not going to deal with you like I do the adults. But you spreading this poison online?
That ain't get your mind right.
We coming for it. Nobody on this planet going to be treated as worse as you. You going to wear it like a sand around your neck. Everybody going to know. Nobody else called niggers, not even Africans. Mm-hmm. Nobody else hung from trees. Nobody else was enslaved. Nobody else everybody scared of, but who? Us.
And see, the Africans that don't like us, they call us Akata.
Mm-hmm. Well, this particular woman we talking about, she dating one of them. So that's why her ass is, you know, in involved in all this treason. But we're going to get with that. You know, she didn't... age of my nieces. I'm trying to stay calm here.
I got
a problem when you misleading thousands of our people. But well, we gonna deal with that.
That I didn't get your mind right, mm-hmm. and he is.
Mm-hmm. So this is what I want to talk about before. This is what I want to deal with. You all need to start listening. Let me tell you something. These movies that you see in Hollywood about slavery and all that's a bunch of bullshit. Okay. Some of it's true, 20-30%. But these house slaves dressed all nice, in the house serving the master and all of that. They had them like that for parties. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? But a lot of this is a bunch of bullshit. It is not reality. The best, and that's what I'm saying, we're going to talk about some books that y'all need to read. Like I said, CBT. Cognitive behavioral therapy, changing your thought process. Okay? What Esau been showing you in the movies is not the reality of slavery. What you need to go back to is like the Frederick Douglasses. You need to go back to the Henry Bibbs. You don't know about those people. Those were actual slaves that lived the experiment, and they actually came out in the 1800s with books describing their experience. That's the real slavery that they don't teach you in school and that you don't even hear about. You did you hear about Henry Bibb? He was just as prominent as Frederick Douglass. But like they do with Martin Luther King, they just put one up front, mm-hmm, and they don't tell you about the rest. These are our ancestors that said, this is how I lived in slavery and this is my story. Like the slave narratives. Mm-hmm. Now, mind you, some of these books were edited by Esau, but more of the autobiography of the actual slaves is true because they could read and write, mm-hmm, than these damn movies you watch. And that's where we coming from. Those are the books I told you you need to read. One of those books is The Narrative in Life and Adventure, Sad Adventures by Henry Bibb. We just talked about him. Which was a half-bloody Hebrew, by the way. Okay? His father was white. His mother was raped. He was conceived. Okay? Henry Bibb can tell you about slavery. And see, these myths that you all have, that I have bloody Hebrew brothers and sisters, that they're not black, really? The word makes it clear. Go ahead.
I was going to say, and that's what pisses me off, because you're talking about some stuff that you don't even know the history.
You don't know. Mm-hmm.
Henry Bibb, for example, it's not his fault he came to the world because his black Hebrew mother was raped by a white overseer or slave master.
Exactly. And that's the thing. He said right here, they will be a sign and a wonder to you and your descendants forever. That means whoever is living the experience of Deuteronomy 28, that's my people. Do you know how many half-bloody Hebrews have been called niggers? Do you know how many half-bloody Hebrews were sold in slavery? Do you know how many half-bloody Hebrews were lynched, shot, and hung, and accused of rape?
And you trying to act like they're different from your black ass.
Exactly. You willing enslaved man, the dumbass.
I'm going to say your name. I'm not even going to go there because you're a female and you're 25 or 25-ish. Mm-hmm. I'm not even going to go there. But I know I defended you when one of my Hebrew men was attacking you. Mm-hmm. So you go and start attacking our Hebrew light skin demographic?
Really? This particular YouTuber, and the reason why she is a poison because she has hundreds of thousands of subscribers and she's spreading this poison.
And this is one more thing I want to say about anybody who gets on YouTube and had a fucking nerve to say, I want to report, I'm not talking about Lisa Cabrera because she has a lane. She is an authentic, I would say,
journalist
mm-hmm, as far as I'm concerned. But, and I'm talking about Paris Milan. I'm just saying your name so it's no confusion who I'm talking about. Mm-hmm. I don't have no respect of no one who jumped their ass on YouTube talking about so-and-so just sent me this article. And then you go and spill your poison into hundreds of thousands of people's homes, or potentially millions of people to come in contact with that poison, when it was someone else who sent you the goddamn story for you to jump on somebody. And my whole thing is, if they didn't send you that link, you would have had no reason to even jump on that person.
Exactly. And this is the thing. We have this group of younger YouTubers that's what we're talking about. That, let me tell you something. A lot of these younger YouTube content creators, they think they're smart and they're awakened. And in reality, what they are, they don't know shit. Mm-hmm. Okay? I'm trying to come to you as an auntie, will you the same age? I know I'm coming hard, but I got to get you because you harming the nation. You think you smart. You think you conscious. But in reality, you extremely Willie Lynch. And you perpetrating plantation fights. You need to listen. You don't know shit. You're not awakened. It's not just Paris Milan. It's the whole ilk of them. They out here as if they fucking know what they fucking talking about. Your young ass, you don't know shit. All you doing is engaging in Willie Lynch, slave man to behavior. Light skin, dark skin, army and this. It's disgusting.
She's
all of them.
Interracial dating and having babies and all. Shut the fuck up.
You don't know shit, baby, child. Know your lane.
And the reason we coming so aggressive on this video is because the time is very near, and once that button is pushed, death happens.
And you don't believe this. We love you, and we want you to make it, and we know your youth is working against you, sweetie. Okay? Because this particular YouTuber I'm talking about, Paris Milan, once again, we go back to Henry Bibb, and he goes into his autobiography and how he was beat and how he ran away 5 times and how he was shot and they tried to hang him. A hair-blooded Hebrew like a Colin Kaepernick.
Yeah.
And we got the same YouTuber on YouTube saying, she got a whole video titled, Mixed People Are Not Black.
Yeah.
Damn it. Do they not experience Deuteronomy 28? Do they not experience being called a bad word? Do you know how many hell-blooded Hebrews? I'm not talking white folks. I'm talking hell-blooded Hebrews that have been called niggers and that were hung and shot and lynched and enslaved. Were they not? Do they not have the same history as us?
Yes, they do.
So what are you talking about? I'm going to tell you what you're talking about. I'm going to tell you like my auntie told me when I was 20 years old, sweetie. Okay, because I'm so upset because you are causing confusion within a nation. You got over 100,000 subscribers and you don't know what the hell you're talking about. And you on here causing confusion. And I call out one name, but it's a whole ilk of them.
Hell, I have your fucking head because you ain't even pointing nobody toward my fucking channel.
Exactly. Like my auntie said to me when I came to her with some information, she said, sweetie, I was about 20 years old. She said, I don't know where you got your information from, sweetie. But you're wrong.
And I believe you believe it.
I believe you believe that. And that's what I'm telling you, Paris Milan and all those YouTubers that's pushing this colorism and mixed people not black. I don't know where you got your information from, sweetie, but you're wrong. According to the Bible, which is fact, and I'm going to prove it to you. It's not your belief, which is fact. According to, he said, my people, my nation will be known by the way they're treated. It's going to be a sign around your neck. Do you know how many hair-blooded Hebrews? I'm not talking about the Willie Lynch ones.
Right.
There's plenty of Willie Lynch full-blooded Hebrews.
Exactly.
Have been hung, shot, lynched, enslaved, raped. Okay. Only no other nation of people have been treated that way. And you had a nerve to be spreading this poison, talking about some, they not black. They not our people. I don't know where you got your information from, sweetie, but you're wrong. Go read the autobiography of Henry Bibb. You're so educated. Go read that.
And don't think you can't be touched. You can be touched at the snap of a finger, the blink of an eye, the wink of an eye, the fucking sneeze of a nose. Mm-hmm. So don't think you so far away or they don't know where I'm at. Trust me.
God does.
And he's the best navigational system that a person can have.
Stop this foolishness. You know what the fuck you doing. Listen.
For Esau's fake ass money?
Right. She one of her latest videos, and this also represents the ilk. The YouTubers on there regurgitating what you're saying.
And I just want to say this,
babe. Mixed people not black.
And babe, I just want to say this.
Men and all this bullshit. It's Willie the slave man to behavior. Go ahead.
And I want to say this. And it's not like God pointed us to your that fucking video you did. It ain't like we looked for it.
Exactly.
He said, talk about this. Address this.
It's a problem.
See, don't no one sends us no links to videos. We let the Holy Spirit pop stuff up and say, no, I need you to address this. That's how we do our shit. We don't have nobody send us links. Look what happened over here. Look what happened over here. No, that ain't how, when you working through the Spirit, that ain't how it work.
And you know, we love you. I know you don't care to hear that. You know what I'm saying? You remind me of my nieces and my nephews. You fall into their age bracket. I'm as young as a five. I had nieces and nephews your age. I'm going to chalk this up to youth that maybe she just don't know no better. Okay? But you causing division. And what you're doing is Willie Lynch slave-minded behavior. You putting light skin against dark skin. That's what you're doing on your damn videos. You telling our half-blooded Hebrews that they're not Hebrews. You don't know what the fuck you talking about. Listen, I don't know where you got your information from, sweetie, but you're wrong. All of you. Okay, not just the one we calling out. All of you. You know who you are. You younger YouTubers. We even had one of them, the Lettuce video, was talking about, they said something about this person is a self-proclaimed
Hebrew Israelite.
What the fuck is that? I had to hit my Bible because I wanted to call you a bitch.
Neither is or you ain't. Ain't no self-proclaimed.
What the fuck is that? But I wouldn't want nobody calling my niece a bitch. And she 42 years old. I'm about to be 42 next month. So I'm not going to do that to you. So I'm going to say, what the fuck is that, child?
Daughter.
I'm going to keep my cool.
Dear.
I'm not going to come at you like I would somebody over 30. What the fuck is a self-proclaimed Hebrew Israelite that you just put up on your fucking channel? I didn't know you could self-proclaim a ethnicity. It's not a religion.
A bloodline.
Child.
Daughter.
I want to say the B word, but you're younger. I'm going to respect that. But my patience is short because you got people listening to your bullshit. And I know you've been to this channel and you know better. You need to listen, stop being hard-headed. You know what? Because your ass going to be right here. You're not exempt. You're going to die with Esau. You keep pushing his agenda. There's no such fucking thing as a self-proclaimed Hebrew Israelite, sweetie. Daughter. That's an ethnicity. You dating an African, right? You dating a Nigerian. Are they self-proclaimed Nigerians or are they fucking Nigerian? Are you stupid or what? No, you're not. Stop spreading this poison on land. I'm sick of it. Babe, I need a... You got anything to say? Because I'm trying not to snap on her ass like she's a real fucking grown-ass woman. I don't want to do that. Because I wouldn't want anybody to snap on my niece that's her same age as that way. I'm going to chalk that up to age. And you thinking you know shit that you don't. You need to listen and shut your damn mouth.
And it's not just for you.
You don't make videos mixed people aren't black. That's your... We gonna get on that. You don't make videos about Hebrew Israelite being self-proclaimed. That is an ethnicity. That is not a self-proclamation.
And the way she did it, self-proclaimed Hebrew Israelite. This is a way of them trying to usher in. It's okay to be with white having baby with white folks. That ain't. You putting a false narrative out there as if it's truth. Or you might as well be saying that's what we trying to do. We trying to give the permission to do that. And we're not.
Lord help me, Jesus, Father God, to be. See, the younger people, they didn't used to have platforms. And now they got platforms and we got to get them. I'm sorry, but I got to get you. I love you, but I got to get you. I don't know, like my auntie told me, so I say to you, I don't know where you got your information from, sweetie, but you're wrong. Stop the bullshit. Or your ass gonna be right here. I love you though.
Nah, she ain't gonna be right here. I'm just your what's gonna happen? Your energy is just gonna be recycled into the universe. Your ass will be gone. I would rather that happen for you to be left here and have to deal with the hell that's coming. Cause that'll be easier on my heart.
You are way too intelligent. You heard this message and you know it's the truth, and you're spewing this bullshit. And for the rest of our Hebrew nation, I'm sorry that you have to hear this, but we're talking to our younger Hebrew content creators that's 25 and under, that's spewing this bullshit and this divisiveness, Willie Lynch slave-minded behavior. They act like they're awakened. They don't know shit. Listen. Get your asses on code. I love you, but if you don't do it, your ass gonna die right with Esau. You know damn well, Hebrew, what the fuck is that? Self-proclaimed Hebrew Israelite. Paris Milan, you know better than that shit. Okay, you dating a African. Go ask them if your ass is African. Go ask them that. Ask your boyfriend that. And I want to hear a video of him saying.
And put his punk ass on there so I can see what he looked like.
Right, we've seen him before saying that your ass is his people. Since we self-proclaim Hebrew Israelites. Since we not really Hebrews. Then get your ass on land and say. Let your boyfriend say, yeah, no. Let your African boyfriend say, oh, no, they're African like us. I want to hear the motherfucker say it since we self-proclaimed. As if that shit not real. In reality. Spreading this damn poison and these lies.
And the last time I checked, y'all ain't married. And the last time I checked, you're probably doing shit you shouldn't be doing when you ain't married.
That's what I'm saying. You're going to bust hell wide open. You need to check yourself. Don't come for it. Sweetie.
Daughter. Bang, bang.
That's right. You in a different position because you got hundreds of thousands of people listening to you. Get your ass on cold. Child.
Or get eliminated.
Okay. Don't do that bullshit. Nobody playing.
And when I'm telling you,
I would say to my son.
Not yet. What I'm telling you, I tell to any fucking leader of any fucking nation in their goddamn face. Get the fuck on cold on what the fuck I'm telling you to do. You're going to get down, you're going to fucking lay down.
Colorism. She one of the main ones in the ilk. Chrissy and all these motherfuckers, these young motherfuckers. Let me tell you something. I'm not going to call them bees. Okay, let me get my chi back. Lord, let me.
Yeah, center yourself.
Help me because I love our women and I love our babies. And the thing about young adults is so hard because they actually think they fucking adults.
Yeah.
They're legally adults, but you don't know shit. Okay, and then they don't want to listen when someone a little bit older trying to tell them to listen. But you know, the consequence of not listening this time, your ass gonna be right here with Esau, with daughter Babylon. I'm telling you.
You don't want that.
You don't want that. I'm telling you, you need to listen to the prophets. We're telling you to shut the hell up. If we say, don't push colorism. Light skin, dark skin, and all that bullshit. You really didn't slave mandate younger people. That I had a nerd that had YouTube channels. We telling you, don't sit here and bash our men. You really enslave mandate younger adults. Do it! Or your ass gonna be here.
And it goes vice versa. Men don't bash our women.
We love you, but that's just reality, boo. Sweetie. Child.
Daughter.
And I mean it. I love you, but I'm sick of it. Because I know they've been to this channel. And they're deliberately going against what we said. Your ass going to be right here.
Well, you think going against our message
is going to stop it?
It's going to stop it or it's going to keep you relevant? You've been usurped. You usurped back in September 2018.
Jesus. This one of these YouTubers actually have a video titled, Mixed People Are Not Black. Once again. Like my auntie told me, so I say to you, I don't know where you got your information from, sweetie.
Dear.
But you wrong.
Child.
Daughter. As long as they living under the curse of 28, God considered him a part of his nation. All half-blooded Hebrews. Do you know how many niggers Colin Kaepernick been called with nooses around?
I can imagine.
Okay. They living. They ancestors were slaves too. Now you got some that's Willie Lynch and they choose to go with the parent of their oppressor and be Willie Lynch and slave minded. That's fine. But you have half-blooded Hebrews who are living the Hebrew experience as God said it'd be a sound around your neck. How dare you tell them they don't have a right to their inheritance when they share it in the curse. Once again, I don't know where you got your information from.
Probably
sweetheart, but you're wrong.
Probably your Hamite boyfriend.
Yeah.
You're different.
Yeah.
Because I'm with you.
Yeah.
You still a fucking Akata to them.
Say that again, babe.
You still make a sure. Fucking Akata to them.
Yeah.
African, no, it actually means black cotton picking nigger.
Exactly. But she running around trying to find a dress to a wedding. You put that shit online. Okay?
Wait.
That's fine and dandy, but don't cause division among self-proclaimed Hebrews, sweetie.
You talking about Hebrews sleeping with Esau. But are you, should you be sleeping with a Hamite at this time when we calling for separation?
When they sold our ass. They was the ones that sold our ass in the first place. Oh, but you're around friends and you got the nerve to be talking about self-proclaimed Hebrews. Okay, when you take your ass to their wedding, go ask them, are you they people? And see what they say. Record that shit and put it online. See, I want to know if they tell you, I love you, you are people. Paris Milan, since you know so damn much. Sweetie.
Daughter. Dear.
Child.
Beloved.
That's right. And I'm going easier on you than I would somebody over 30. Because I'm going to chalk that up to youthfulness.
Yeah.
But once we tell you something, and I know you've been to this channel, and I know you heard it, and you're continuing to spew that bullshit that's dividing our nation, causing division among this time, that's when it becomes a problem, sweetie.
Dear.
Daughter.
Child.
We love you, though. You don't think that, but we do.
And yeah, and instead of getting to your feelings, get your fucking mind right and get on board and on code, so on a narrow path that's going to lead you out of here.
And that's for Paris Milan and those that follow you and all the rest of you YouTubers that's 20 family underscore this bullshit. You don't know shit. Shut the fuck up. And listen and learn. Go back to lesson 12, part 1, and work your way up to 7. You don't know shit about where our nation is headed as a Hebrew. You got the nerve to sit here and say, and those that self-proclaim Hebrews, what the fuck is that?
A death sentence for her?
Like we some radicals, as if that's not an ethnicity. So your Nigerian boyfriend, he self-proclaimed Nigerian? Why the fuck is he Nigerian, but we self-proclaim Hebrews? Sweetie, ask yourself that. Tell me you not Willie Lynched and brainwashed and indoctrinated that you even say some stupid shit like that. But you know everything with your young ass. We love you, sweetie.
Daughter, I might save the bullet. I might just send lightning to strike your ass. That way it'd be quick and painless.
We may we have to pick this up. I'm getting so drained with all this. We have to pick up part 3 tomorrow.
We can do but, that. I can put puff and enjoy my life. Come back and ride on your ass tomorrow. It don't matter to me.
Another book by Lewis Hughes. Go read that. You college educated younger folks and all the rest of you Hebrew nation. He was another half blooded Hebrews, and he goes into great detail about Esau's women and how they were treated. The house slaves, how they were beat. And you know, by the way, the house slaves didn't have beds like the movie show. The house slaves had to sleep on the kitchen floor and in the attic, on the floor. So while you have this notion that house slaves had it so great because they were lighter skinned, they didn't. And they were getting their ass beat by the women of Esau. Read the autobiography for yourself since you know so much. Did you know that?
Of course not. She was educated in Esau's college and school system.
All of them. You don't know shit. You need to listen. Because, see, we've been warning you. Listen. And when you don't listen, we got to come for you because you're causing division.
Okay? Light your ass up real quick.
Yeah.
Like the song said, I go 0 to 100 real quick.
We had a galvanize. You calling division, causing division, talking about gender wars and light skin, dark skin, and all that is Willie Lynch, slave-minded behavior. Y'all ass is supposed to be conscious. And some of the men had enough nerve to shut the hell up.
Exactly.
The younger Hebrew YouTubers that was making noise and we came against it, and they had enough sense as men to not go there. These younger YouTube women, they still flapping their gums as if they got a fucking stance. Your ass is gonna die. You better listen.
And
nobody playing with you, especially not y'all.
And something else about me. I don't go to sleep, mama, so good night ain't the word.
Another book. The History of Mary Prince. She was a Hebrew sister. She goes into great details about our Hebrew ancestors in the West Indies. Okay. And the Caribbean islands. That's another thing about these YouTubers. You too intelligent. You know damn well we saying we were scattered over all four corners of the earth. And that our people, one nation enslaved another. Esau, which the Most High Yah refers to as the European nations. He refers to as Esau, enslaved another nation, which is Jacob, and scattered us into four corners of the earth. We went over this in several videos. That's the West Indies, the Caribbean Islands. She has her story, excuse me, her autobiography about the trauma and detriment that they went through in the West Indies and the Caribbean Islands as a result of slavery from the Atlantic slave trade. Mm-hmm. Who are you to come along and say, well, you, since you weren't dropped off in America, you're not our people, and you know, we're going to get on that further because we got a whole nother section for that. That's why I'm going to need to take a break. We're going to have to pause this after we're done with this part, because this drains me, because this is something we've dealt with before, and we got to tell you again. Jesus. Bae.
Hmm?
You know, in the West Indies, they used to have a ring. You know, when a slave displeased the overseer or the slave master, they would form a ring of at least 50 slaves, and all the slaves were to hit that particular slave,
mm-hmm,
and beat them to almost unconsciousness. There you go with the Willie Lynch, perpetrating the Willie Lynch slave master behavior.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And before we go to our next part, I want you to know, that's how we know Latinos and Native Americans are not our people. Because Deuteronomy chapter 28, verses 25, I'm sorry, verses 45 through 46 says, they will be a sign and a wonder to you and your descendants forever. Native Americans weren't hung from trees, they're not called niggers, and they weren't enslaved. Only we were. Mm-hmm. Neither were the Latinos.
Right.
It's really, it don't take a rocket scientist. That's how you know your people.
Yeah.
Haiti, Jamaica, the West Indies, the Caribbean Islands, Virgin Islands, America, the UK. We were the ones hung, shot, lynched, enslaved, called niggers.
Raped.
That's how you know it's our people. And that's going to bring us into our next point, where we're going to be back after this break. Okay, so we took a break. You probably won't notice in the video, but we had to take a break, like I said, because that part drained me, when you have to repeat yourself and it's being redundant and you're trying to help people and actually wake them up and they going against it for mm-hmm. whatever reason. A lot of you all, like you said, you haven't even seen our faces yet, so you're not upset with us as much as you think. You're upset with the message, and mm-hmm. the message come from Yah. So you get offended by that. Don't shoot the messengers, right?
Yeah, because I always say the messengers shoot back, bang, bang.
Okay, so we're going into the last part of this video. And like I said, we're covering a lot in this video because we haven't been on in almost 2 months, so we had a lot to address. One thing I want to discuss, and I hate to do this, I really hate to do this, and I'm gonna tell you why, but it's ridiculous. I mean, these our people, they don't listen, you know. Some of them are starting to. Okay, so I want to make a very clear point here. I want to be very clear. Listen to this, catch this. Your opinion does not matter in this world. Okay. Did your mom ever tell you that? Your grandma? Your opinion does not matter in this world. Only facts do. I'm going to repeat that. Can I say it one more mm-hmm. time? Your opinion don't mean nothing in this world. Only facts count.
And I'll go even further. If you go to my playlist under What's the Message, if you listen to that video, heaven does not value your ideas or your opinions, only your participation at this time.
That's right.
That's all heaven requires, is your participation. Heaven does not value your ideas or your opinions at this time, just your participation.
You're not in a position to suggest anything to the Most High Yah anyway. Okay? Because we want to deal with reality, because see, we have a lot of people out here, and we've addressed this before, and that's why I had to take a break to come back, because I'm getting tired of it. We're trying to help you. this window about to close and we getting on that. Mm-hmm. When we say your opinion does not matter in this world, only facts do, because that's actually reality. Mm-hmm. So that's what I want to talk about. I want to talk about reality, okay? And what is fake? And what's opinions? Which is a bunch of magic beans and fairy dust, pink and purple dinosaurs, unicorns and fairies, a world of make-believe. And what who's operating in a world of make-believe right now is this fake, once again, mm-hmm. hashtag ADOS movement, and this fake hashtag cut the check movement. Mm-hmm. Now they started cut the check. Mm-hmm. And that's what I mean when I say I really hate to do this, because I've had to get on these people. Do they understand that this is the Most High Yah's message for his nation? You don't come against it with your own shit. That's not reality. That's magic beans and fairy dust. God sets what's real and what isn't. Even with Esau. Mm-hmm. He been ruling for 500 years with his fake money system and all of that. That's going to crash because it's not real. It's not what Yah said would continue forever.
It has already crashed. It's just being held up because the world can't handle it right now.
This fake-ass hashtag cut the check. They all in the comment sections. Yeah. It's disgusting. Cut the check, cut the check. Y'all sound so stupid. Lord help me. Listen up. These people, and I give some, these people have created their own slave nation. We got some people online who are heading this up. Mm-hmm. And they created their own slave nation, and that's what I said, that's magic beans and fairy dust. And I give that particular quote because I cite my works to a channel called Jabbing Bullets, but I've been known that. They have created their own slave nation. We say, God say, he wrote over 2,000 years ago what would happen to Israel, where we will be at today, the second Exodus. They come along and say, no, no, no. Mm-hmm. We want to stay in America mm-hmm. With the oppressor, mm-hmm. and we just want them to cut a check. Wow. Mm-hmm. Dude, that's the stupidest. Okay.
We're going to be here until we're not. Meaning, the prophets already told you this process is going to be 3 to 5 years. So you either got 36 to 60 months.
Yeah.
Starting, I would assume, starting in 2020. Well, it actually started in 2019.
Now.
Mm-hmm. It's 2019. So from 2019, this process is going to be completed within 3 to 5 years. 36 months. Or 60 months.
Let's deal with reality, because let me tell you something for you John Henry Clark students, okay?
Let's call them disciples.
Disciples.
of his
false doctrine. Whatever. So that's what we want to talk about, you know. Before you said that point, I was talking about, you know, what's real and what's magic beans and fairy dust. You know, and that's what I was saying about these students of John Henry Clark. These disciples,
yeah, that's what
you
they
know
are.
That told you that our history is fairy tales. No, what you're saying is fairy tales. It's magic beans and fairy dust. It's complete utter bull crap. Listen, as I said, we saying let's back to Israel. They saying, oh no, cut the check here. That's so stupid. What are you gonna do when Esau come shoot your kids? How is that supposed to help anything?
And I know this, if you're saying that, don't call the prophets.
Yeah, they all in the comment section. It's disgusting. Okay, so, and another thing, that's what I mean. They created their own slave nation. The Bible is clear. The Hebrew nation, our people, not Africans. We have 10 lost tribes. We have 10 tribes in Africa that belong to us as a nation. All other Judah, we were scattered into four corners of the earth. I've gone through this. That's why I had to take a break, because I'm tired of repeating myself. But this is the last and final time. The people and some of the people that's heading up this fake ass cut the check movement, they are too intelligent to not know what the hell we're saying.
Or what they're doing.
or what they're doing. They get it.
Deceiving people.
Yeah, deceiving people, and they get this message because it makes sense. And they're intelligent. Yes. Intelligent black society.
Yeah.
They're intelligent enough to know that this only makes sense.
Yeah.
But because they want to keep the sale of their DVDs and they want to keep their YouTube channel, they are deliberately deceiving a bunch of gullible people, yeah. Our people.
Yeah.
And they fall. Our people falling for a hook, line, and sinker. And this is the last part we want to talk about that, because the Bible says, history says, you can look it up, you can Google that. You don't need the Bible. Google it if it's not the truth. One nation enslaved another. Esau enslaved Jacob. It wasn't just America. It was the European nations enslaved one European nation. Don't matter. The Bible says, and history will tell you, okay, what the Bible already predicted. Go look it up for yourself. Okay? That's reality. What you're talking about is, that's the bullshit. Okay? That's magic beans and fairy dust. We were dropped off into all four corners of the earth. Okay? So that means Esau enslaved Jacob. It does not matter what part of the corner of the earth they dropped us off right. in. We still one nation.
Yes.
You idiots. And you know that. You know what you're doing. Okay? I'm more concerned about these gullible Hebrews all in the comments. Ooh. Saying, cut the check. Reparations. You all sound ridiculous. It's the most disgusting, ridiculous
First of
thing.
All, they can't cut a check for you even if they wanted to, because the government don't even have money.
Well, this is the thing. And this is what I thought about. Okay? Like I said, this is nothing but a higher grade of Willie Lynch slave mandate mm-hmm. behavior that the leaders of the cup, to which they say they're not leaders, but they own land.
Right. Talking and leading people to hell.
Yeah.
With them.
Yeah, with them. And so they are basically saying that this cut the check movement. Listen, first of all, Esau told you to kick rocks. That's the video yeah. we put up, which we knew he was gonna do. He's not gonna give you anything. He's the leopard that don't change his spots. He never was gonna give you nothing. He never will give you nothing. When it happens, it will be forced. You do not have the power to do that. So what are you pushing? Magic beans and fairy dust. It's a bunch of bullshit. Okay, that's number one. Number two, you understand that we were dropped off into all four corners of the earth. So that's what I mean. This is just another level of Willie Lynch slave manly behavior among these so-called leaders of the cut the check movement.
Mm-hmm.
Because what we're seeing is those in Jamaica, Haiti, the Negro race in the Cuba, the Negro race in the Dominican, the Negro race in Haiti, we have so many, you know, the UK, America, the Caribbean islands, the West Indies. We're saying those are all the descendants of slaves from the Atlantic slave trade worldwide is the Hebrew nation. That's our people, not Africans.
Yes.
They're coming along and being Willie Lynch, saying, no, forget everybody else in the other parts of the world. We just gonna deal with America.
Right.
So that's just like the Willie Lynch letter when you said,
Put the this against that one.
Right, the hill in the valley right. where you live. That is so Willie Lynch slave man and disgusting behavior. Because what you're essentially saying is, we don't want to unite with our brothers and sisters worldwide, which is our Hebrew nation. We just want to deal with America. And they're immigrants. Nigga, you an immigrant.
You an immigrant, exactly.
We all involuntary immigrants. That's the stupidest thing. But what's more disgusting is that these people are echoing this bull crap. Cut the check.
Well, you echo nonsense when you're afraid to fight for what's yours.
Yeah, because they could easily say Solomon's gold.
Yeah, Solomon's gold.
They could easily say
That's something that history biblically is yours.
And we gave them modern, go back to lesson 12 part yeah. one, where we proved that they actually have our stuff.
But you a lot of y'all are so ain't even past the first chakra clearing of fear. That you afraid to fight for what's rightfully yours and belong to you.
You rather talk about a check of fake paper money. And you know what?
Monopoly money.
Yeah. And, you know, I thought about this. And this is before he put his foot in his mouth, because we're about to go there. I thought about this when they were running around talking about cut the check. this is what I get. And this is what the Lord gave me. First of all, if Esau was to just go ahead and cut you a check, which is something they probably would eventually do, because it would work in their favor, you idiots. Esau would probably give everybody $20,000-$30,000 each.
Mm-hmm.
And simply because Hebrews own nothing,
mm-hmm.
we control nothing,
mm-hmm.
we have no industries,
mm-hmm.
we're not going to do anything but take that $20,000-$30,000 and put it right back
in his hand. And you're going to be in the same position.
Because we don't own shit. In the meantime, the police going to be still killing our kids. We still going to be mass incarcerated. We still going to be undereducated. We still going to be oppressed. We still not going to be able to afford politicians. So
housing, a lot of stuff.
Cut the check is magic beans and fairy dust. That's not going to do a damn thing. And then you know what? I knew this. But then Jason Black actually came along and said it. And I'm glad you said it, Jason Black, because I knew that because... this is the stupidest thing. You all are engaging in magic beans and fairy dust. You all are listening to these people who only want to, they only care about selling their DVDs. They care nothing about our liberation, obviously. And like I said in previous videos, my heart was a little broken about that because I actually thought they cared about the people, but they don't. Because they're too intelligent. They know what they're doing.
Mm-hmm.
Which is deceiving gullible ass Hebrews. Listen, cut the check. We're going to hold our vote. Let me tell you something. Esau don't give a fuck about your vote.
It never was about your vote.
You, these are people. You dealing with a reprobate nation. This is an ancient old battle. They have hated us. Two nations are in your womb. They've hated us since the womb. Go back to, like I said, lesson 12, part 4. These people would rather die. Do you understand? Let me repeat that. Esau would rather die, D-I-E, he'd rather be dead than do right by you.
Than give you anything that is rightfully yours or you deserve.
He'd rather give his life than give you anything. And you think he gonna move for a fucking vote, dumbass? Jesus Christ. That's common sense. You should know that. You shouldn't even be saying hashtag cut the check. Esau will never do right by you. Ever. Name one time in history that he did. I'll wait. Even the civil rights movement. When Martin Luther King, when they signed the Voting Rights Act, guess what they did? They put a 25-year expiration on it. Why would you do that?
Because Esau's always been an Indian giver.
He's going to take it back. He'll never give us nothing. They extended it in the 80s with Reagan, another 25 years. What the hell did they just do 2-3 years ago? Cancel it.
Mm-hmm.
They took it back. We don't even have voting rights. Something that our ancestors, our forefathers died for. They took that shit right back. 50 years later, that's why they put an expiration on it. And that's exactly what their evil asses is going to do with a fake-ass cut the check movement. They gonna throw you $20,000, $30,000. They know we don't own control shit. We don't even own banks. It's gonna go right back to the white banks.
Mm-hmm. You buy a car with that, it's going right back to Esau's hand.
And it's not because we stupid and dumb in that area. We just don't own anything. So we don't have a choice but right. to give it back to them. That's the stupidest idea. Hashtag cut the check. Get the hell out of here. That's common sense.
Yeah, but you know the old saying is common sense ain't always that common.
Yeah, that's what my mama used to always say. Wow. Now, like I said, then they come up with another master plan. One of them say, each nation, we in America, they stuck to America.
Mm-hmm.
We in America, we say we're going to get your own land, your own government. No, we're in America, and we're going to get our cut the check, and then all the other nations, they can get their cut the check. That is magic beans and fairy dust. That's not what the word predicts. That's not fact. And whatever God predict is what's going to happen, just like he predicted we was going to be in this beast for 500 years. Ain't that what the hell happened? He said he coming for his people from all four corners of the earth. He didn't say, oh, you get your cut the check in America. You get your cut. They're going to come up with their own slave narrative, magic beans and fairy dust pink and purple dinosaurs, unicorns, and fairies, world of make-believe, bullshit-ass plan that means absolutely nothing, it's not going to do nothing, and it's not going to get the police from killing us.
And so what I'm going to do, I'm going to come up with my own unique way of eliminating you individually. And it's gonna be epic. It's gonna be horrific, and I'm gonna enjoy it.
Cause you all are in the way. You know what you're doing. You way too intelligent. I will give you that. You too intelligent. You know what you're doing. You know you're making a fool out of your own nation. They take advantage of that gullibility. And I guess the nation is going more so with them because that's it. We're gonna hold
out. Because they're afraid that
Esau would rather die. He would rather get his damn life than to do right by you. Why the hell would he do right by you for a freaking vote? You know what? They would create a new party before they did. The Democratic Party don't give a fuck about your vote. They would rather create another party than give you a vote, than give you anything. They don't care nothing about your vote. They don't care nothing about you. That's not gonna work. You're dealing with a reprobate group of people. Jesus, that's common sense. But they, and then what you fight for, 20,000, 30,000 each, I already knew that's how much you're going to get. Hell, we get that damn near for income tax check. What is that going to do?
No.
That is nothing but a glorified income tax check. 60% of us don't even own property. First thing we're going to do is run out and buy a house, which you should. It's going to go all to the white banks, all to the white mortgages. What the hell is $20,000?
Nothing.
And they selling it, and y'all act like y'all taking power. That's, they saying it's powerful. How the hell is $20,000 powerful? I'll wait. But no, Jason Black explains it. You know what? Because I want to play that clip. Mm-hmm. And then we'll be right back. Jason Black explains it. Let's break down. This is his master plan. His magic beans and fairy dust bullshit that y'all been online echoing. Okay?
And after these messages, we'll be right back.
Brothers and sisters, when they cut the first check, it's game over. So they can't afford to break us off a piece and cut us off a slice. That's going to backfire horribly. They can't afford to do it because there will be too many black people who are going to be able to empower themselves independently. You can't give them any of it. You can't give them any of it. Imagine a situation where a black person had, let's just say $20,000. You got a whole bunch of black folk who are going to be able to flip $20,000 into $100,000. It's just before now they didn't have the leeway or the luxury or the financial wiggle room of being able to do so. But now that they're able to, they'll be able to do that. And you're going to be in a situation where you're not going to be able to move that. They're going to be able to act independent of you. They're going to be able to act on their own and independent of you. And they're going to be doing things that you can't control. So they can't give you any part of this, which is why, notice what they're doing, brothers and sisters, they're shutting down the conversation. So they're willing to talk about transsexuals and gender identity and abortion on demand. They're willing to talk about literally everything. They're willing to institute and initiate a discussion about literally everything except this.
Okay. Did you hear that? I knew this was his plan all the way because he know all we can really get from Esau is about 20,000, 30,000 each. This con artist just sat up here on this video and said that what he just said was, once they cut the first check, they know that the game is over.
Yeah.
What game over? How's the game over? Can they still mass incarcerate us after the first check?
Yeah.
Can they still shoot us in the street?
Yeah.
Okay. Can they still disenfranchise us and not give us jobs?
Yeah.
Okay, so how the hell is that?
Can they still send one of their snitches when we actually trying to put something together to come and tear it down like they've been doing throughout our history, using our own to infiltrate our ideas and then go and run and tell Massa, and then Massa come shut it down, and now all of a sudden the FBI all on your ass?
Can they, this reprobate, he also said in this clip, With $20,000 individually, too many black people will empower themselves. That's the stupidest. Magic beans and fairy dust. He care about selling you his DVD, Race War. Listen, Revelation 12 says, and the whole goal of the beast was to wage war on us and to conquer us. That's your, you ain't got to pay $20, I just told you.
And I'm saying you don't have to worry about that because I'm here now. And like I said, I want all the smoke.
And so he said, now we saying come together as a group. We here to galvanize.
Right.
Group economics. Everybody else had group. But he telling you your empowerment come
individual.
Back individually getting $20,000. When you know $10,000, $11,000 of that going to be you paying your damn credit cards. That's the y'all, and y'all listening to it and echoing it. It's disgusting. If you want to know who are part of the two-thirds that's not going, these are the perfect example of these people and all and those that follow them. They are going opposite of God's agenda, and it's going to fail. It's not reality. It's magic beans and fairy dust. You John Henry Clark disciples. People like Nicole's View and Terrain Rain, you know, they in their 30s. You know, their behavior, like I said, I know both of them has been to this channel. Every time Jason Black or Professor Black Truthfort, you know, that Black Empowerment ilk, the Willie Lynch people.
Come up with some scheme, they jump right
on it. They jump right on it like two little lackeys and put up a video. Now, we told them to, you could easily say hashtag back to Israel.
Right.
But you would run up, and Terrain Rain love to say ADOS, ADOS. You know, he wants to be a descendant of slaves instead of a descendant of Abraham. And you so loyal, you some of you YouTube channels, to these reprobates that's leading you with total bullshit. $20,000 supposed to be your liberation. Not voting supposed to be your liberation. Okay? You want to be so loyal to some people that you probably even never met. Your ass gonna die with them. With that shit on your channel. Get on cold.
Then we got channels that, you know, they're talking about what's going on, but you can easily go back and pull up videos, or videos will pop up where they're actually blaspheming Jesus' name. There's something evil about the name Jesus, or they have videos saying that, you know, Jesus' name means dog or something like that.
Spell backwards. And the reason why I mentioned those two particular channels, you know what I'm saying? Because they in their 30s, early 30s, mid 30s, they're a little younger. I see them deliberately rebelling.
It's rebellion
against the message. But I'm gonna reach out to you one more time. Stop this foolishness. You sound like idiots. You want to be a descendant of slave? You love America so much, you gonna die with them. You being loyal to some motherfuckers you never even met. And you never even met us. But what makes sense? Quadrillions in gold, our land back, or freaking $20,000 check.
And not to mention, you ain't never met or seen us, but you have met and seen our power.
Well, you know what? That's the last I'm going to talk to this group of people like this, okay? Because it's about time for this to pop off, okay? So, like I said, they run like two little lackeys. They can't wait. So these people put up something, they immediately echo it. It makes me think that you don't, I mean, are you that loyal to these people, or are you just that against the message for your nation? And you know, Terrain Rain, I think he kind of struggled with the fact he don't really want to believe the Bible, that he comes from the Bible. You better get over it, okay? I'm sorry, your opinion don't matter. See, that's what they don't understand. Your opinion don't matter.
Your ideas, heaven don't care about that. Only your participation.
We the descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. That's just fact. You roll or get rolled over. Don't nobody care about your opinion.
You ride or die.
I don't know about all that Bible stuff. That's your history. Your ass gonna die. See, they think we just be throwing that out. They don't understand. You know what? As he predicted the beast, and as he predicted the second Exodus, he predicted two-thirds of y'all ass was going to die because you won't listen and you won't get on cold. I'm trying to help you. I won't call you sweetie because you're in your 30s, but you're a little young. I'm trying to give you a chance. That's why I called them two out. Y'all better stop this foolishness. ADOS, cut the check. We stopping voting. What the? Oh my God. Voting ain't never did nothing for us and never will. You're beating a dead horse.
And see, I'm not into the voting shit. I'm into hostile takeovers.
Exactly.
I'm into taking over the government by force. Fuck a vote. I'm the man now. Ain't no, you don't have to vote for me. You gonna see me in the fucking seat.
That's right. And these people, and they're the same. The new black media, let me tell you something. I don't know if you all know math. You're intelligent. Intelligent Black Society. Jason Black and the ilk of you. 10 years is not new. Okay. That means you had your ass online for a decade. You ain't did shit.
Ain't did shit.
That's what that means. 10 years, we're new. We've been on less than a year. You're not new.
Yeah.
So I don't know what. See, that's the trickery that they use.
That's one of the tricks.
Idiots are falling for it. Jesus Christ.
The new black media has risen up and then had a nerd include themselves in. We're the new black media.
Right.
Y'all been out 8 to 10 years.
No, let him. 10 to 12.
10 to 12 years, and we're still in the same fight. Farrakhan been out 60, 70 years, and we're still in the same fucking boat.
Right. So go several seats.
Go take several seats.
You know.
Or I'm gonna take several heads tonight.
Well, you know, like I said,
tonight. Because we have to let this harsh message sink in before I start cutting your fucking head off.
And they don't really understand, especially me. You're a little different, you know. But I be praying for these people. I be wanting these people to get it. And sometimes you just gotta let people go.
Yeah.
You know. And
it's
no different than Abraham crying out for Sodom and Gomorrah when Moses cried out for when they started worshiping the golden calf. That's the heart of a prophet. We don't want to see anybody fall because we know what's coming. It's certain. Once we see it, that's done. And we telling you, if you do this, you not going. And it pains me to see them constantly make these decisions.
Mm-hmm.
Like Terrain Rain, ADOS, when he know better than that shit. Okay. And I know what your fate gonna be if you don't listen.
And
Jesus, but I can't make you do it.
And that's why I can sleep well at night, because at the end of the day, everything that I'm seeing in the spirit, everything, every little, if you want to call them doorway the Holy Spirit takes me through, I can sleep well at night. I can eat. I can enjoy my family. I can enjoy my life, because at the end of the day, I say, Father God, let your will, not my will, be done. So if you send me on a mission with a list, hey, that's his will. It has nothing to do with me. I'll probably be like, hey, I like them though.
You know, that's the thing. I lost my thought there, but you're right. Like I said, you can't say we didn't warn you, you know. You can't say we didn't warn you. You definitely can't say we don't love you, because we do. Because I wouldn't even be going over this.
Wouldn't he be yelling? And I don't. That's not my natural constants.
You all are so hard-headed. Ooh, stiff-necked people. Jesus.
Mm-mm-mm. I really don't like confrontation.
But no. Some of them, I got to give props. Some of our nation starting to get on cold.
Yeah.
Like I said, that's the remedy.
And babe, like I said, they don't seem to understand. I really am very peaceful. Yeah, I do not like confrontation, but I don't run for shit.
Yeah, and that's what we're about to get on, because we're getting ready to close, okay?
You don't want, it's like you don't want to see that side. That side is very subdued and it's very under control. But like I said, I'm very peaceful in my everyday walk.
Yeah, you have a very, I can say that as your wife, you have a cool, calm disposition. Unless you're in your prophet mode, you get all riled up like now.
Well, again, that's when motherfuckers be trying me and shit.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
I don't run from shit. I don't back down from shit. No. And I ain't scared of shit.
That's what I want to talk about. We getting ready to close. I got one more thing. Remember at the beginning of the video, you know, we had talked to you all about how we talk. Somebody, like I said, didn't like your rap music and all of that. You know, the way you express yourself. That's how you express yourself. Like, all right, you rap. You just write down and you rap. Not trying to get a record deal. That's just how he expressing himself. Now, so you need to understand. I'm gonna close this out. Like I said, this is the last video. I'm gonna talk about this. But you have to understand, our forefather Abraham, Isaac, David, Jacob, Moses, okay? When the Most High Yah, we're his chosen nation. That means he uses us to get his work done down here. I've explained that in several videos, okay? We were under a curse for 500 years because he had to get us back, daughter Zion, in refinery, because he said, you're going to serve me, and I'm going to use you on this earth to do my work. Like Esau, like Lucifer has been using Esau to do his bidding for 500 years. Mm-hmm. Lucifer is a mimic of God, okay? That's how God's going to use us to do. That's why the world going to be so much more peaceful.
Yes.
Okay? We're going to be in Israel. That's the capital. And we will be he will be running this earth through his chosen people. That's the whole reason he has a chosen people. He loves the whole world. And let me tell you this, because this is fact. This is our history. Okay? Whenever the Most High Yah chooses prophets and leaders, usually prophets, mm-hmm. over his nation, like you in charge of the second Exodus. Mm-hmm. Let me tell you something. 99.9999% they will have blood on their hands. Okay? I'm going to say that one more time. When the Most High Yah chooses anyone to lead his people in anything throughout history and even now, they will have blood on their hands. And I'm going to tell you something else. They won't give a fuck. They'll sleep at night just fine. I don't think you understand that. I don't think you get it. Because you're talking about how we talk. Are you serious? That's the least of your worries. You have to understand, for you to be called for what you do and for me to be on the side of you called for what you do, do you think we actually give a damn who die? We don't. We're talking about our nation. We're talking about the nation of our enemies. Man, woman, child, we don't care who die. We only care about our liberation.
And the remnant that's coming along, as well as the rest of his people in the world. He loved the world who serve and serve Jesus Christ, his son.
And we don't care anything about our liberation, our gold, and back to Israel.
Our precious artifacts, our ancient technology that they got stolen and hidden.
Our shit back.
Yeah, we want all our
shit
back.
We got a one-track man, especially you. Mm-hmm. Abraham, read the book of Jubilees and the book of Jasher. Abraham wasn't no punk. Once again, he was a prophet that God used to head up his nation. I told you, anybody he called to lead anything in his nation, most likely going to have blood on their hands. When you all need to understand history. They got Abraham in the watered down 66 books that you use. Listen, our forefather, when they kidnapped his nephew Lot, Abraham was like, oh shit, where my Glock? Mm-hmm. He took 200 men of his men from the house. They slaughtered four cities. He killed thousands of men with his own two hands. Blood on his hands. Okay? Isaac, same thing. The father of the 12 sons of Jacob, which is the 12 tribes I named after. Like I said, they slaughtered, like we said in another video, five whole cities. Mm-hmm. David, I already talked about him. Okay. Moses, same thing. You understand? Yeah, the Exodus was one thing, but once they were in the wilderness, they were surrounded by enemies. Moses was a killer. What am I saying? I'm saying, if you understand what he called to do, what we called to do, then you understand, and the stamp of God prophets is they do not care about the blood of their enemies, then you will not be offended by how we talk. That's the least of your problems. Motherfuckers is finna die and we gonna sleep just fine. I could care less.
Right.
Okay, that's what you're dealing with. That's what we were born to do. You get it? Do you think they get it?
I hope so, because like I said, we were born to do this because he knew we were not going to have a bitch-ass heart.
That's right. You got to have hearts. And you're going to talk like you have hearts.
They see me, they run.
and you're going to back that shit up. That's God's prophets that he called a lead. Go back in history. Abraham, David, Moses, Isaac, same thing. We're not making this up. We ain't nothing new under the sun. Okay. So with that, I want to tell the story about how we are so itching to pop this off. You just called. We testing a little bit. You called the White House. You like, mm-hmm. I want to speak. She want to act like, who are you?
Right.
You cussed out.
I cussed out. And then, I called the White House and I said, hey, I want to speak to Trump. And the first thing she said, the president is busy. Just showing me off as if I ain't no goddamn body.
Then you cursed her out. And 2 days later, the White House flooded.
Yep.
Now, I know that that D.C. flooded, the area flooded anyway.
But in parts of Baltimore.
In parts of Baltimore. But the White House basement should not have flooded. And like I told you, God always confirmed his prophets. He wants them to know, I can reach you too, because you cussed out. You said you don't know who I am. You're going to know who the F I am. And I told him, I said, Daria, why you do that? But like I said, we so ready to pop this off. We waiting on y'all. No, we still got to wait on
people. At the end of the day, I felt it's disrespectful. If I call and give you my name, I told him my name is Daria. I also go by the servant of the Lord. I'm trying to get a message to the president. And the only thing you say, the president is busy, that ain't my question. I didn't ask you, was he busy?
That's right. But also, we like I said, we waiting on the nation. What we trying to tell you, we had a power.
But I have to let the president in the White House in Washington, D.C., and the surrounding states know they can be touched.
Exactly.
Just like that.
That's what I'm trying to say. We waiting on y'all. We ready to pop this off. Okay? And the cut the check movement don't have that type of power. They can't do shit. We waiting on y'all.
The moral of the story is, whoever the fuck I call going forward, y'all better act like you know my motherfucking name, Daria, or the servant of the Lord. When I present that to you, your secretaries, whoever answers your fucking phones, whoever handles that, when they hear Daria or the servant of the Lord, please get the message to who I'm trying to get it to so they can call me back.
That's right.
But if you act like you ain't who like I'm just some rat, and you gonna act like you gonna send me to a switchboard?
It's gonna be more than your basement flood at the White House. But like I said, well, we gotta hold it up just a little bit because we waiting on them to Jesus. Okay, it's time to pop this off. We itching to do it. All right. So with that, family,
we love you guys with the love of Christ. until next time. But this should hold you guys over. We got some more kingdom business to take care of. We're going to be...
Get on cold.
We're transitioning into our new lifestyle. Looking forward to it. I'm actually excited. We're actually going to be hands-on, meeting a lot of you guys.
Mm-hmm.
Touching the ground with you guys.
That's right.
We will not be these faceless voices anymore. Going forward, after we have I requested the Holy Spirit and God the Father to give us a little transition into this new lifestyle before we just really hit the ground running. So he has granted that. So as we transition, mm-hmm. We will still be putting up videos and stuff from time to time, and we'll still be dropping in to let you guys know what's going on.
We ready to serve
the people. But we ready to serve the people. We're going to be amongst the people. We're going to be amongst you guys.
We ready to get y'all out of here.
Yeah.
We ready to go. Let's do this. Okay. Yeah.
So until next time, we love you guys. Shalom.
Shalom.
About niggas and bitches, power and money, riders and punks. Which side are you on?
Hey, look here, homie. I've been with these niggas all day, man. They talking about killing your ass for that money, man. Show them that shit. Cause if I have to search for it, it's gonna be over your dead body, homie. And that's on the real. Where that shit at, nigga?
Hit the same 16 and broke. Bang for the green, put the nigga in the choke. Kicking in the dope, nigga, what a dope. Any hoes home, tie the pieces in the rope. Living in the scope, another murder rope. Why you gotta die? Cause the sniper got a smoke. Vanish like a ghost, another nigga toast. Should've had a soldier on your motherfucking post. Searching for the lows, killing for the notes. Taking all 150s in the fancy coats. Cause I've been hurting for the most.
this shit for cash. Maybe it was a setup, but I can't let up, cause if I do, they probably wet up my crew, and I'm more fed up with this than you. Head up, you fool, we don't play that shit, you can say that shit, I'm dangerous. Armed and bringing harm, and if we get caught up, the judge gon' hang us. But I ain't giving a fuck, I be living it up until I'm locked. In a 5x7 cell, or 6 feet deep with that nigga mugshot, cause I'll be damned if I let him pull some shit, and don't be back on that block, and be wanting the rocks, with the money and socks. Your honey's a fox, funny she got all over my job when the tummy gun got hot on your spot.
Searching, earning for certain, looking for a come up with a quick pass, give a nigga whiplash when it kicked ass for the cash ass. I'm searching, earning for certain, looking for a come up with a quick pass, give a nigga whiplash. Tell
yo,
me what that cash
got me searching, but I really don't know what I'm searching for. See, maybe it's the nigga that I hurt before, or maybe it's the nigga that I'm working for. Tryna hurt me toe, work me hoe, till I'm coming up off cash stacks. When the drunk, I make a nigga have flashback, get his ass smacked, then his mask crack. Then I dash black as I smash back to the hood that the nigga called Ghost Town. Plenty nigga, plenty bitches getting broke down. Put a trigger, then a stencil get smoked pow. But I'm hurting though, damn I'm broke. Stand on the corner drinking 40s. All of my niggas be thinking I'm crazy, be hollering, slow down, shall we? Slow down, shall we? But if I slow down, will I still be able to go clown? Will I still be my props when I throw down? Let me know now, cause I'm hurting for certain, looking for a come up with a quick pass, give a nigga whiplash when it kicked ass for the cash ass. I'm searching, hurting for certain, looking for a come up with a quick pass, give a nigga whiplash. So tell me where that cash stands. Searching.
And I'ma be pumping around from the virgin Glock. Give a nigga fire like Tupac. Back on your block like mugshot. Better be buying your grave plot. Biting my shit to get paid, nah. I'm coming through the door with the fofo like Popo when they on the raid. But I'ma be searching that bitch to get paid. Looking for the cash you stashed away. What's the safe house if it ain't gon' pay? Watched your ass the other day. Looking through the lens of my scope and the days today. I'm searching, hurting for certain. Looking for a come up on the quick pass. Give a nigga whiplash. Tell me where that cash. For your ass get smashed, you know I got my ear to the streets, and I hear your heartbeat, and I know you stuff the stacks every week. I got your bitch how she talking shit about fuck you, giving up info that lead to the lick this hoe gotta go to, cause she know if she put two and two together it's 2-4, so I gotta make a killing when the glove hand touch stacks I'm drilling. We talking on CBs, coast clean, no coppers to pop off in red beams. They flee the roof, get ghost back to the hood to have a toast. Keep your lips closed, especially when talking around in wild hoes. This did be the paper and merch, what a nice pay for the day I search. See, we was searching, we was hurt for certain, but a nigga didn't come up on a quick pass. Now we give a nigga whiplash, fucking with our cash dash. I'm searching.
Paid the cost to be the boss, that's how I feel. These niggas can't fuck with me on the real. I'm Naftali, known for blazing beats for my niggas in the streets. Hustling hard, trying to make them ends meet. Peep, just another day, another dollar to make. Another spot to shake, another op to break. Pop my collar for some dollars, now it's time to floss. Rolling all alone with my bitch, Nina Ross. Hustle and grind, fuck a 9-to-5, gotta get mine, using my minors was my 9, nigga, fuck doing time, struggle for years, now I shine like mop and glow, don't get it twisted, I'm a Windy City rider for show, I still ride for my clique, die for my clique, pull my 9s, empty clips and start popping shit, I hit them up like Pac, fuck with the best, your best bet, wear a vest, every day, we ball, dress fresh, picture me rolling, up the block, in something LS. From drops to trucks and them coupes on chrome. Tell the po-po's to leave me alone. It's crazy, I tell ya, the life I live. No stranger to ones, but I'm all about them Benjamins kicking back. Smoke weed with my friends, watching flat screens in the baby blue bins. If them people come get me, I got money for bail. The type of nigga that'll never spend a night in jail. Keep my mind on my money, stop chasing tail. Cause these days, bitches scheming on how to take a nigga's mail. Industry take over, invades my mind's eye. They dreaming, wishful thinking, know it could be the fucking high. I won't rest till I'm billboard number one, living the life these niggas kill for. Back to the flow, gone off hydro, hella weed. Keep me on my P's, ballin', stacking dollar B's. Me and my niggas letting off hits off in this industry. And I won't quit till my name go down in history. Just another day in the life. Just another day in the life. Just another day in the life. Just another day in my life, motherfucker. Just another day in the life. Just another day in the life. Just another day in the life. Just another day in my motherfucking life, nigga.